Welcome back to Terva Wars. We find ourselves returning, possibly for the last time, to the troubled city of Aquilonia. Recently, the city has become under attack by hordes of the undead and demons, when suddenly, the zombie apocalypse seemed to stop. The undead and demons ceased their assault. Leaving Aquilonia citizens and defenders confused and unsure of what to do. However, they could still hear the great bells coming from the citadel. And they knew Holy Kaiser is still in peril. All the faithful who still can race to his aid, ignoring their reanimated comrades milling mindlessly about them. Just as the attacks have seemed to stop outside, the party, composed of Alar Thorson, wielder of Mjolnir, Terry Brothblood, Elfric Youngblood, King Alaric Caen, and various lords of the south, still find themselves locked in combat in the Cathedral Citadel, in its most inner sanctum, Holy Kaiser's throne room. Allow me to set the scene. Deep within the Baroque halls of the Cathedral Citadel lies a throne room of unrivaled grandeur and oppression. The walls are tall and imposing, made of cold stone adorned with grand stained glass windows, many of which lay shattered upon the ground, their jagged edges reflecting the red light that pours through them. The room is dominated by the mithril throne, a grand seat of marble streaked through with veins of shining mithril, possibly the most precious resource on the material plane, known to have magical properties. This amount of mithril is an obscene gesture of wealth. Even Rotherham, at the most, can only boast a chain shirt. Carved upon the mithril throne's vast structure stand statues and imagery of angels and saints, their stony gaze seeming to watch over you all, judging you with dour faces. The room's floor is made of checkered marble, smooth and cold to the touch. Upon it lay a large black and gold mosaic in the shape of an iron cross, with the words Ein Reich, Ein Kaiser, Ein Gott written upon it in bold letters, the motto of the Holy Iron Reich. The red light that filters through the broken windows gives the room an oppressive, hellish glow, casting long shadows upon the throne and the mosaic. It is a room of power and fear, made for a living god to sit upon and rule the land with an iron fist. The echoes of the past still linger, whispering of dark deeds and foul rituals that were done within this hall. It is here that the party, you guys, fight against your most powerful foe yet, Holy Kaiser. The Holy Kaiser, an emperor of unparalleled power and malevolent intent. Contempt and disdain are etched upon his handsome and radiant features. His long dark hair and pale features are the picture of regal splendor, but the cruelty in his eyes reveals his true nature as a malevolent tyrant. His mithril plate armor, invulnerable to all attacks, and his golden laurel crown, symbol of his authority, are a testament to his power. He attacks with a golden warhammer-headed flail, Armageddon, made, what do you call it? By force? Unwillingly. Yeah, unwillingly by the dwarves, imbued with the power of hellfire. Beware, adventurers, for his wrath is terrible, and his strength is without equal. That is setting the scene. Finished. As we begin, we are reminded of the sacrifices made in our last session. Wolfgang Regenstaufen and Richard Leon, both great warriors, were killed in battle against Holy Kaiser. Alexander Balian showed great courage when he saved Alaric's life. While Alar Thorson has raged, a terrible visage of his godly father, he has annihilated the Kaiser Guard and other reinforcements. We also bear witness to the Holy Speaker, who was killed in the line of duty as collateral to one of the Holy Kaiser's fireballs. The party knows the stakes are high, and Holy Kaiser is a formidable opponent, his wrath so far unstoppable. As they prepare for their next encounter, they know they must use all of their prowess, knowledge, and critical thinking skills to defeat this enemy, or the world will be plunged into darkness. To further recap, as Alaric Caen stood toe-to-toe with Holy Kaiser and barely survived his fury with the aid of Alexander Balian, he witnessed the deaths of the other lords. He knew that victory was beginning to slip from his grasp. But Alaric was not one to go down without a fight, not while he had one trick left up in his sleeve. With a fierce determination in his eyes, he began a process known only to himself and true-born dragons, channeling the blood powers deep within himself. The air around him began to shimmer and crackle with energy. Suddenly, with a deafening roar, Alaric Caen transformed into an adult golden dragon. The Aquilonian reinforcements, taken aback by the sudden transformation, stumbled backwards in shock. Alaric Caen's body was now covered in shining golden scales, his limbs elongated into powerful dragon legs and wings. His arms had transformed into massive claws, each one capable of rending steel. Fire danced in his eyes, and his breath was a scorching inferno. With a deafening roar, Alaric lunged at the Citadel guards, his teeth and claws tearing through armor and flesh with ease. His wings beat the air, propelling him off the marble floor and sending them flying. The guards, now outmatched and outmaneuvered, faced their inevitable doom, but their zeal and their captains prevented their outright rout. All they could do was hope, but in vain, for Holy Kaiser to save them. But he would not. With another roar, Alaric Caen breathed a cone of fire upon the remaining guards, reducing most of them and the body of Richard Leon to ash in seconds. As they fell, Alaric Caen let loose a mighty roar of victory. Unbridled power seeped through his veins, and his enemies lay defeated at his feet. The feeling was intoxicating. Why would any dragon choose to live as a human when they can feel like this? Alaric thought of Arthur, who often lived and ruled as a human, and for a moment regarded his memory with contempt, and for a split second, humanity in general with contempt. In the aftermath of his carnage, all the mortals in the chamber could do was look upon the king with awe and fear, for they knew he was not just a man, but a dragon, and that he possessed power beyond measure. Elfric could not help but contain a wicked smile. After this fierce display of power, a group of archangels led by Azrael, the Archangel of Sacrifice, appeared, blocking off Aquilonian reinforcements, which there were many, coming to Holy Kaiser's aid. The angels radiated and continued to radiate a powerful and holy aura, and Holy Kaiser could only stare in disbelief as they stood between him and assured victory via overwhelming numbers. Azrael spoke in a powerful, resounding voice. The fate of the world shall be decided in this room, for good or ill. None more shall influence its outcome. It has been decided. The party, strengthened by the presence of the archangels, know that the fate of the world rests upon their shoulders. With the angels in Aquilonia watching, they prepare to face Holy Kaiser in a final, epic battle to determine the fate of Terva and the world. So ends the recap.
And scene.
And scene. We begin with Holy Kaiser's turn. Because it was stupid, we tried to end on it last time. So, it's been... We are back to the top of Holy Kaiser's turn. Everything that was done in it has been undone. So, as we begin with Holy Kaiser's turn, he turns to Alaric. He regards your dragon form with his trademark contempt, and you proceed to attempt to batter him with your wings. He resists it. The succubus next to him gets thrown flying. He speaks to you at the start of his turn. Alaric Caen, he says.
Don't cost him an action.
Well,
sorry.
It's...
Sorry, go ahead.
He's got something cooking. Alaric Caen, he says, brushing himself off. Or just, I don't know. He doesn't brush himself off. He's above that. You stand before me a dragon, yet you are nothing, he says. Your transformation is but a mere trick of dark magic, a fleeting illusion of power. You believe yourselves to be mighty, but you are nothing compared to the true power I wield. Holy Kaiser will attempt an intimidation check against Alaric. Alaric, choose either your charisma or wisdom modifier and add that to a d20. That will be the DC of this roll.
You said just straight charisma or wisdom?
Yep. The modifier. But remember, whichever one you choose, roleplay-wise, that's what you're using to counter this. So it's either your just, like, if it's charisma, it's like you're so charismatic and, you know, sure of yourself. It's like, okay, I know what he's doing. Like, that. If it's wisdom, it's just, I don't give a fuck what he says. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So.
I'm going charisma.
Okay.
15.
Wait. 15.
I think I have it. Nope. Wait. I guess not. No.
And, like, even if Holy Kaiser beats it, like, I'm not expecting you just to, like, well, shit, you're right. I give up. Like, you know, it's just further down the line, roleplay-wise, you know. Let's see if he can throw some doubts in there. And I don't know. Maybe if he beats it really bad. We'll see how it goes. To Alaric. Postmarked. You, repeating what he just said, believe yourself to be mighty, but you are nothing compared to the true power I wield. I am a scion of the one true God. I am the one who commands the hearts and minds of mankind. My power is not in the shape of my body. I need no foul tricks like you. My power is in the strength of my will. The power of magic is nothing compared to the power of flesh and devotion. And he, like, pans to the vast carnage before him of all the people who's laid down their lives for him. You, Alaric, have foolishly placed your faith in the strength of your dragon blood, but it only betrays your nature. Your humanity is corrupted. You have sacrificed it for this, gesturing at your dragon form. But it will avail you nothing. You are a poor and a weak ruler. You lead your kingdom, your family, and your friends to ruin. Your resistance is futile, for I am the true master of mankind, not some dragon half-breed. I am the one who holds the destiny of humanity in his hands. As I have written, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Hearken then, King Alaric, for I, Holy Kaiser, give you this one chance. Know that I am not some mere despot debased and lecherous. This is the most you've ever heard him speak. For I am the incarnate of God. You have dared challenge my rule and opposed my holy will. Your defeat is inevitable, and it only further dooms your people. But know this, Alaric, I do not seek your destruction. I offer you this one final chance for redemption. Repent of your treachery and turn to me. Seek forgiveness of your sins, and salvation will be yours and all those you care for. Let us not prolong this conflict any longer. Surrender to my rule, and let's put an end to this bloodshed. Hear me now as I say to you, I am the true ruler, chosen by the cosmos, and my rule is absolute. But know, if you continue down this path, then you shall face my unbridled wrath. Vengeance is mine, I will repay. So saith Holy Victor, so say I, the master of mankind. What say you, Alaric Caen, king of the misguided? Now he will attempt his role. He has a plus 10 to intimidation. 22. So that's got to hit a little deep. Maybe you believe him a little bit. A little doubt seeping in. What you thinking, Alaric?
I think he's nothing but a pawn of Asmodeus. I think he's more misguided than he'll ever believe, but...
Is that what you say?
Yeah. That,
I mean, that's a good response.
You're nothing but a puppet for Asmodeus, and you always have been. Any success and any devotion you've found along your way to occupying this throne has only been, because Asmodeus has guided you there. You either are trying to convince the world of your godlihood, or you truly believe it, and you know not where your power even comes from. My power is... This power I'm using here and now is what I have worked for, what I have earned it, or, you know, I don't know. He's probably not going to go too hard into that one, but still.
You want to go ahead and do a persuasion roll back to him? I mean, you hit the persuasion pretty good right there. The only thing I'd say is just like on first hearing Holy Kaiser, like in what he's saying, and just like it was maybe just a little doubt that maybe not that what he's saying is true, just more of like, fucking Jesus, yeah, this guy's pretty fucking tough. Can I even fucking beat him?
Maybe sure.
That thought. that just would, lingers in the back of Alaric's brain.
Like, yeah, definitely the thought of, like, shit, dude, if he's just getting started, like, fuck. Like, he rocked me earlier, like, can I even handle it from here? But, yeah. But I'm gonna do a persuasion back. Got a 19, but okay. I do have advantage on persuasion.
Oh.
That did not help. I got a 19.
Holy Kaiser is not impressed by your words. You speak of Asmodeus, he says. Your words are but the rambles of a fool, King Alaric. You are a selfish wretch, and you have led all who follow you into ruin. He asserts a more authoritative tone, as if the chamber were full of 1,000 rabid believers hanging on to his every word. You, King Alaric Caen, deluder and deceiver, has sealed the fate of those you profess to care about. Your friends, your family, and your subjects, they shall no longer be offered salvation because of you. I decree anyone who has followed you or supported you shall die a heretic's death, from the strongest warrior to the smallest child. They shall all be nailed to a cross because of you. The tyranny of dragons upon mankind is at an end. For all of mankind, I will destroy you. All you have tainted shall be crushed underfoot of the faithful. So say I, Holy Kaiser, let it be done. And he uses power word stun on you. If the target has 150 points or fewer, it is stunned. Do you have 150 point health points or lower?
I have more.
Aw, shit. Well, you brush it off then.
And Alaric stands in his dragon form. We'll just kind of like rear up a little bit more and kind of flex his wings up a little bit. Just making it clear, like, no, I'm not going anywhere. He says, you fight with monsters and demons, and just because you have an audience here to sway, we will not forget that Asmodeus stood not 100 feet from here. I am not disillusioned, and I will fight for my people and this land. That's okay. It. And he's just going to square up.
Everyone definitely knows that Holy Kaiser just sent some sort of, like, evil, powerful fucking spell at you, which now I have to cross off.
There could be, like a almost ripple in the air effect as it, like, goes towards him or something, like a wave.
Oh, yeah. Like, Holy Kaiser's eyes go gold or whatever. Like, it's... And Alaric, you could feel it, like, coursing through you, sort of like, I'd say if it would feel like a really powerful, like, shock, like electric volt, like, stuck your hand in a fucking outlet, but no more than that. Like, anyone else, that would have just, like, paralyzed them, but your dragon form, pretty tanky.
Yeah, and that's why he kind of squared up, like, no, I'm gonna make you fucking know it didn't work on it, I know you tried.
yeah, that was an action to cast Power Word Stun. So, and cantrips. It says whether you can. Yeah, no. Never mind. Yeah, he doesn't have any cantrips he can use like that. He can cast plenty of spells at will, but not. Yeah, not
baby spells.
Yeah. Well, maybe this one. Let me look it up. I'm assuming. Nope, action. Yep, they're all actions.
It's just funny that there's a lair of Alaric that's just like, as he's saying this, he just kind of looks around and it's like, you're standing next to a succubus. There's an imp right there. Devil in the room.
Yeah, the guards didn't see that, though.
I know, and that's why he said, just because you have an audience here.
The four guards that are left. Well, I mean...
And there's people at the doorway.
It's up to debate for you guys, because you don't know for sure whether Kaiser's high on his own supply, you know. Does he believe the things he says? Is he being, you know, duped by his Asmodeus? How many people would really even know that's Asmodeus looking at them? Like, he's in his fair form. Like, Asmodeus is supposed to be like a giant hulking, well, not hulking, but just a big red dude with horns. Like, when he shows up looking like a hot bachelor ready to open up a bar, it's like, I can believe he's the god of man. I don't know. I know, but you guys don't. Anywho. It is now... Yeah, because I'm not even going to have him move. He's just going to stand right there. It is now... Balian's turn. What is Balian going to do? Let's see.
He's been fighting that group
there. He's got some health back. He's got some health. Yeah, he's just going to attack the group. So, attacks with his long sword, plus 9 to hit. He makes 3 attacks. 11 is not enough. 20 is... Oh my god. Oh god! Okay, 2 criticals. Yeah, so 2 are dead. With those 2 criticals, I'd say he killed their captain. So, I don't know. He kind of went hog wild. If we're doing the... I'll keep it. He killed their captain, so they have lost retreat as heresy, so they can now be terrified and whatnot.
Oh, yeah.
Balian is... I mean, he gets in there. He's been healed by Terry, feeling the protection of from good and evil. He is ready to go. So, after his turn... It is Prize's turn, and he is going to, let's see, Flynn Prize. Oh, well, let's look that up. He would just attack the one right next to him. Okay. He is going to make right next to him. He makes 2 attacks, and one of them is just going to be a normal arrow into the incubus right next to him. But then he is going to do a lightning arrow at the last 2 guards. But he's going to try and do it in a way that the lightning hits Alaric.
Ooh.
So, first attack, because he's seen you wielding Mjolnir, and like, figures you draw power from lightning, so he's like, I've done a lot of bad this time, being under control of these demons, but I'm going to do good, boss. So he shoots his first arrow into the dude. Yeah, it definitely hits. So that is 13 damage. bringing this incubus down to one health. Which maybe he should just finish it off, but nah, he's got a plan. So that incubus is just barely fucking alive still on that, on the top of the mythal throne.
And terrified.
And terrified. Yeah, of Alaric. But he's just whoosh, and then zzz, whoosh, into the guards. So, lightning arrow, make a ranged attack, make the attack as normal. So. 16, it hits. Target takes 4d8 lightning damage. So the guards, the last two guards are fried. Aller, I assume you don't want to try and get out of the way of this lightning.
Not particularly, no.
You are hit with 2d8s of lightning power. And you gain 11 hit points.
I'm good with that.
If you're at max hit points, then they're temporary hit points.
I am not at max hit points.
Yep. Let's see, has he already done all of Nature's Veil? Oh. As a bonus, Prize is going to attempt the hide action. So... make a dexterity stealth rule. If you succeed... well, the only person who's really next to him is the... and, like, would be paying attention to him is the incubus, who's at one hit point, but sure, we'll roll to see if Prize can hide again. So, he has a +5 to dex. 16, the incubus has a passive perception of 15, yep. Prize is hidden, so we'll give him a little ninja. Ciao! Okay. That is the end of his turn. It is now Terry's turn.
Hey, got a quick question for you, unrelated to Terry. But I know I mentioned something about this before, but I don't remember if we said anything about it. With Alaric's dragon form still having legendary actions, and we were talking about how his three legendary actions are tail attack, wing attack, and detect. The dragon makes a wisdom check, and that's it.
Yeah.
Is it asking too much that instead of detect as a legendary action, could I cast as a lark through this form a cantrip?
I, just for balance sake, okay. I'm just going to keep it at polymorph turns you into an adult cold dragon. You get all the benefits of an adult cold dragon, including legendary actions and resistances. I think that's enough.
Okay. Like, with...
You know, like, maybe in the future, if, like, Alaric's all by himself and alone and, like, wants to devote, like, a month to unlocking further potential in his dragon form, sure. As it stands, you can turn into an adult gold dragon.
Okay. So, with Terry's turn, how is this demon dude in front of him looking?
That is a swarm, and basically nobody has hit it. Like, they've just been pestering Aller, and he's just been basically invulnerable to it. But there is, swarm of imps. So, they are currently, like, swarming, or, like, attacking Terry, but they're more of just a nuisance than anything else.
Okay, Terry is going to, with a bonus action, cast Branding Smite on his hammer. And, light it up with a flaming, brilliant, radiant light. And, start swinging on the swarm, I guess, with the... I'm sure swinging a hammer through a swarm of, you know, nymphs would still be effective here and there.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, they're actively, like, trying to, like, sting you and shit, so you could very easily hit them. All you gotta do is try. Just further confirmation that Terry picked the right side. If the imps are on the enemy are on your side, you might start thinking about being the baddies. Are we the baddies? And Terry already had that thought when they put an entire city to the sword. Like, I think we're the baddies. Yeah. Yeah, we are. You got a fucking problem?
I think we're the baddies.
Oh, okay. Actually, I do have a problem.
Yeah, because Terry's being a
little... And I'm going to solve it with this smite!
19. Against the swarm.
You got him.
Alright, I'm going to swing again, because he's got two.
Oh, ooh. My god!
That...
Get... Bow god, Kang!
Alrighty. For the first attack, that is 12. That is 12 plus 10 radiant damage.
Ooh, radiant?
Radiant.
Okay, so minus 20.
And then for the second one, how do you want to do the critical? Just double the roll and add modifier, or what do you want to do?
What the fuck does critical roll do? That's what we've been doing.
I think they double the roll and then add the modifier. Okay,
there you go. There you go. Double the roll, add the modifier.
So I rolled a 9, so that's 18. No, sorry, I rolled a 4. So that's 8 plus 5.
Okay.
13. And that also gets 14. That radiant damage.
That's radiant?
No. I have to roll for the radiant on top.
Oh, okay.
Oh my god. Oof. And 2 radiant damage.
Which turns into 4 because they're vulnerable to it. I mean, as you're swinging this warhammer, any that you come in contact with this radiant damage just explode. Like, just guts glory everywhere. And you're able to kill, I don't know, 10, 15 of them in this 6 seconds. But there's quite a few of them. Like, it's a lot of imps.
Hell yeah.
Anything else for the turn? That was pretty gross.
Brutal.
Like, okay, and like, you feel in that 6 seconds you've killed maybe 10%. Like, let me, like, this is a, like, swarm of tiny imps. Like, AoE spells will be the way to deal with this thing. Oh, yeah. But, you're, like, ewy.
I think that's it for Terry.
Okay. Speaking of those little devils, it is now their turn. And they are going to attack you, Terry. Oh, yeah. I forgot I had to print it off. Swarm of imps. They +8 to hit. 26.
Ooh, yeah.
Must roll. So, again, with these swarms, it's really variable on how much damage they do. They could roll really high, or they could roll really low. So it is 8d4s plus 5.
Jesus.
Total of 20 piercing damage, and you must make a DC 11 constitution saving throw, taking 10 poison damage on a failed save, and half as much on a successful one, and you are paralyzed if you fail.
Jesus. You said a constitution save?
Yes.
Oof. That's a...
DC 11.
I also get a plus 4 on saves because of the...
Don't you guys have a bunch of stupid auras?
Yeah. So, Alar and me, we both get... So, plus 9 total. So, that brings that to a 21.
Yeah, it was... I was not expecting that to go through all of these fucking bullshit
just
auras.
Just gotta remember these auras.
Hey, they're stinging you. Like, I mean, these are like they're more than like bat nuisance. They've like Alar is wearing the celestial armor of Thor. That's part of his help. But there is still like hundreds of these imps.
Gotcha. Okay.
For now.
Like, cause they like. It was a couple that came in first, but then, like, literally from every window, like, that's what the majority of the demons that have been, that, like, attacked Aquilonia were. It's just these little imps, supported by a couple big boys here and there.
Yeah, and of course I have, like, no area of effect spells. Oop!
That is the end of their turn. Which means... It's Alaric's turn, or Elfric's turn. Other character.
Hey, before I lose my chance, can Alaric use his last legendary action to use a tail attack on the Kaiser?
What's its range?
15 feet.
Yeah. Okay. You swing around. Give it a whack.
Give it a whack.
You can try!
23
hits.
Alright. I'll make this fast for you, Andy.
No, you're good.
23 bludgeoning damage with my thick old tail.
Okay, half that because of the mithril armor. What's half of that? 11?
Yeah. Okay. All right. All you, Andy.
Is there anything like? Does he have any checks to make over that? Like, be knocked prone or something?
Mm-mm.
Okay. It is Elfric's turn, Andy.
All right. So Elfric is gonna move right here to the center.
Okay.
And then he's going to use his action to summon the Children of the Night, which he can do once per day.
Okay.
As long as the sun isn't out, I can summon 2d4 swarms of either bats or rats, and I'm going to do 2d4 of bats.
Okay.
3 bats.
I got 3 bats.
3 individual bats.
I thought that would be a problem. They will arrive in... 1d4 round.
They're not even here right away. Okay,
and
one turn.
Next round, I'll get my 3 bats. And
they're normal bats, though, right?
Yeah, they're normal bats.
Are they normal bats?
Or
is it swarms of bats?
Is it swarms of bats?
Magically calls 2d4 swarms of bats a rat. So
yes, swarms of... Okay, that is a lot better.
Three swarms of bats is a lot better, yeah.
And he's just going to stand here and try to look dramatic.
But they're not even here.
Then the bats will burst in behind him next round, and they'll start swarming around him.
If the archangels let bats intervene,
the archangels aren't like.
They put a magical field on the windows, and they're just like bugs to a zapper.
They don't have a magical field, or well, they could probably do something. Let me see.
I'm sure they could do something. I'm just assuming they wouldn't. It's a few swarms of bats.
First, let me see if they could do anything about it. Because I mean, they're going to see like this swarm of bats heading for the thing. It's just whether they give a shit enough about bats, like. Is this really worth stopping?
Yeah. Well, Alfred wants his bats.
Yeah. Okay. Actually, Andy, they can cast Blade Barrier. You create a vertical wall of whirling razor-sharp blades made of magical energy.
So,
You can make the wall 100 feet long, 20 feet high, and 5 feet thick.
The bats can fly. They can come in above it, right?
They're just going to put it in front of the windows.
Oh, goddammit. Okay.
Okay. Legitimately, the angels do that. They see the bats coming, Andy, and I'm sorry, but they put up the field of razor sharp blades, and the bats just go in it like a meat grinder. Blood guts just like
Elfric is just going to like look up at this angel right here. Oh. And just he's just gonna do this number, like, really? And just
ah, man, looking at that angel's picture, what do we think he's the archangel of?
Being a dick to bats, apparently.
Like, I kind of want to know his reaction to Elfric getting, like covered in the blood of his bats as they just get lawnmowered. He looks pretty regal. Maybe,
That's what I'm thinking.
Like, he's got a big sword. Looks pretty normal. Maybe, like, the archangel of, like, conquest or warfare?
Yeah.
What's like a virtue?
Justice?
That has to do with... No, there's another one for justice that's got like a blindfold. Maybe.
Honor?
Yeah, the one with the big... The one to his left, or our left, with the big book in front of him, that's the Archangel of Justice. Yeah.
We could just say combat in general. He's just a combat beast.
He's just combat, like leader of armies and shit. Whose armies? I don't know. But kind of like Michael, like the Archangel Michael.
Yeah.
But I won't definitively say his name is Michael. But maybe I will. Yeah, it's the Archangel Michael. Why the fuck not? Yeah, he snickers at you.
So,
he snickers and kind of shakes his head, but doesn't have any more, like, I don't know, after fighting the Kaiser, and, like, the Kaiser just, like, exudes contentment, the Archangels are not actually giving that vibe to Elfric. They're more like, I don't know, Elfric, you are taken aback that this Archangel is not just looking at you with pure disgust, and more just, like, lighthearted amusement.
So Elfric's just looking at you, is like, is he just not taking me seriously? It's pissing him off, so Elfric's just glaring at him now. Like, really, you fucking asshole? I've been doing all this for years, and this is what I'm getting? Elfric's like, a little pissed that he's not being treated as an actual, like, he's being pissed that he's being treated as a nuisance.
I really want to, like, nail that home on how shocking it is that this angel is not sneering at you with disgust and contempt. Like, anyway.
So it is weirding Elfric out.
Anything else on Elfric's turn?
Nope. Elfric's just gonna stand there. He's just gonna glare.
Took a whole action to do that?
Yep, it was a vampire action, so I was going to do that.
Wow.
Dude, even looking at the vampire stat blocks from, like, when I've just ran vampires before, I always thought that was the dumbest fucking ability.
I wanted my bats.
I never used it once.
I wanted my bats.
And they got lawnmowered.
Yeah, I didn't expect them to get lawnmowered instantly. Elfric did not
think that they would. I can't help it. The angels just had a spell for it. Like,
Did
they see swarms of bats coming for them? Like, hey, we got, like, this. I guess this is still the orders not to let nobody through, huh, boss?
Yep.
That includes bats! Okay.
That was a whole turn, well, too.
We all know whose turn it is.
Come on, Dragon Boy.
It is Dragon Boy's turn.
Oh, yeah.
You can do this, Toothless. We believe in you.
Alrighty. First up on Alaric's turn. He'll scoot up. But first up is Frightful Presence. Everyone he doesn't like. Succubi, Incubi, everyone, why not? Even the peanut gallery in back has to make a wisdom saving throw.
Are you including the angels? Is that the peanut gallery?
I meant the people at the door, but...
Oh, okay. They, while their captains are alive, they're immune to being frightened.
Who?
The
people peanut at the gallery. Door?
Guards. Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. I don't care. It doesn't matter.
But Holy Kaiser is also immune to being frightened, but the succubuses are not, and neither are the imps. So what do they have to beat?
21 wisdom save.
Oh my god. Is that even possible for some of them?
I know this one, or yeah, this one up here didn't.
The imps make it, have but... a plus one. They have to roll a 20. They do not. They are frightened. The one succubus is... the incubus is still frightened. So the succubus has a plus one as well. Does not. So everyone who can be frightened of you, I believe, is frightened of you. Now, there's a little shocked face. Yep, there it is. Ah! So the imps are also shocked. The imps are already shocked. It's just hidden behind.
Oh,
I don't know where the icon is. Yeah, it's
there. It is.
Yeah, there it is.
Okay, cool. It's just something he can do on top of his attack. So I'm just doing it.
Yeah, you got the surface.
He's got the one bite and two claws, so he's going to start swinging on Kaiser here.
One of the last things we ended on was you asking how the Kaiser looks, and so I'll reiterate that you and him have gone toe-to-toe a little bit, and he took that big hit from Regenstaufen that would have sundered a mortal man. So his cloak and mantle are fucked up. His crown, the laurel crown, probably long gone, but the mithril armor, and he himself is fine. He only bears the slight scar or the bleeding wound on his cheek from Flamebridge.
Okay. One other thing before I forget, I'm just rolling for breath recharge because I don't know if I have or not. So, no.
Yep.
Might as well do it. Coming up, he's going to do a bite attack against the Kaiser.
Go for it.
Eighteen
does not hit.
Figures. Can I do a claw against this succubus and then another claw against the Kaiser?
Absolutely. You have advantage on the succubus because she's prone.
Dope.
Yeah, she is.
Go ahead and do her.
Go ahead and do her, yeah. 33.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I'm just about to eviscerate or just bring the whole hand down.
She has two hit points left. Let's see how far in the negative you get her.
Oh, I'd love to.
Claw. Here we go. Two of them. There we go. 16. Okay.
She's at negative 14 health, and she is, what, ripped in half?
Oh, yeah. Just, like, bring the claws, like, through the halfway, yeah. And then just rake backwards. Just nothing. Like, swallowing a bug.
For as irritating as Holy Kaiser and his mithril armor are, like, everything else, your claws just slice through like butter, including her.
It's nice to have a reminder in between attacks, you know? So I'm going to go back to him with the second claw attack. Oof. 18. Nope.
Does not.
Two bad rolls against him.
That would have probably hit most anything else.
That's really all I can do. And I'm, like, I'm pretty sure we've covered this before, but just to be sure, Kaiser is immune to fire. We've discovered that, right?
Yep.
And not, like, just not taking partial damage, like, full-blown unaffected by fire, right?
He is invulnerable to fire.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure you did breathe fire on him.
That's what I thought, and that's what incinerated his cloak and a lot of his other shit, but he was fine.
Yeah, like, if not, like, smiling underneath.
Okay, cool. That's, all Alaric has?
While we got Master going, the Master of Mankind is going to use a legendary action to lob a fireball at Alexander Balian.
Hold on. Real quick. Let me see something. I'm going to use my Sentinel feat.
Okay.
I guess I can't stop the attack, but when a creature within 5 feet of you makes an attack against a target other than you, you use a reaction to make a melee weapon attack. Oh, melee weapon attack. Can I still do a claw?
Is it described as a melee weapon?
Melee weapon attack. Well, let me see what his...
Yeah, what does claw say?
Melee weapon attack, yep.
Okay. Yeah, okay. You'll be able to make a...
I was hoping I could intervene. He technically can. In human form, he can use his shield to, like, actually impose, but I don't think he can do that since he doesn't have the shield.
Okay, so Bright Streak flashes from Armageddon and shoots and blossoms with a low roar into an explosion of flame centered on Alexander Balian. 20 feet radius, so yeah, everyone including the imps, but they're immune to fire. Balian, Eller, and Terry have to make a dexterity saving throw, DC 26.
Oof. Well, all three of us had 9.
Not even.
You said dex?
Yep, dex.
Alright, this is Terry's.
So adding 9 to it.
Got a 27.
Ooh.
Oof. Yeah, add 9 to whatever modifier you already have to your save.
Okay.
I have no modifier for Aller.
For your saves?
For a dex save.
Your saving throw normally has a little bit more, maybe.
The saving throw has a plus 5, but that's from the aura, so that's included in the plus 9.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So I have a plus 9 and then no modifier, actually. I have 22.
And Balian, with the modifier, has a plus 14. Okay. So Balian and Terry, you take half damage, and Aller will take half damage because of the celestial armor authority. So... it is 8d6.
Oof.
Yeah, I'm not pulling any punches. You've killed quite a few of his allies. So that's what, 16? 16 yes. damage for all of you?
Yeah, 16 would be halved. Rounded.
Yeah, Alar has the 22 dex save, and then they have from the... You said it was a 21 for the dex save. So it would be a quarter, it'd be half of the 16.
No, the DC is 26.
Oh, okay, I thought it was 21. Yeah, never mind.
No, it's 26.
So minus that's, 16.
That's Holy Kaiser's AC, maybe that's where you put that.
Yeah.
I think you guys have thrown enough punches at him, you know where his AC is. Okay, so everybody takes 15 health. 16.
Alaric's gonna make his claw attack.
Cool. Okay. Well, that's the end of your turn, so you can't do a... Even, like, that, you can't... It's still technically your turn. You can't do a legendary action at the end of your turn.
It's a reaction.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about the sentinel thing. I'm sorry.
14 slashing.
14 taken down to half. Because of the mithril is... 7? Yeah, 7, mm-hmm. Duh. That's a direct. Okay. It is Aller's turn.
And Aller is going to actually use the casting abilities of Mjolnir to cast Destructive Wave, focusing on the swarm here. So what Destructive Wave does, you strike the ground, creating a burst of divine energy that ripples outward from you. Each creature you choose within 30 feet of you must succeed on a con saving throw or take 5d6 thunder damage, as well as 5d6 radiant or necrotic damage. Your choice. I choose radiant.
Oh, shit.
And be not Holy prone. Fuck. The creature that succeeds on its saving throw takes half as much damage and isn't knocked prone. It has a radius of 30 feet, and I get to pick what's affected by it. So I'm literally just going to slam it, and I'm going to pick only the swarm. And I'm just going to nuke the entire swarm at once, because it's doing radiant damage. And you said the radiant damage was just blowing the fuck out of it.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so... You Constitution saving throw, what's the DC?
16, because I'm taking it from Mjolnir.
Okay. They have... 1. They have a plus 1. 11.
Fail.
Okay, roll for the damage. Roll for the thunder damage first.
Alright, so we got 5d6.
Take that outright.
5d6 outright. So... And it's going to be the same for the radiant. So 5d6... For thunder, that is 19 thunder. Roll again for the radiant. That is 16, so 19 and 16 is 37 total.
What's 16 times 2?
32.
Yep.
So that'd be 51 damage.
You total. Are certainly the god of thunder. Like, you strike the ground, creating a burst of divine energy that ripples outward from you. Like, you strike Mjolnir at the ground and just... That's so cool!
Yeah, I just boom and fucking take out these fucking imps. And then,
yeah,
And then Aller stands back up and he just spins Mjolnir in his hand.
That easily killed half of the remaining imps.
Fuck yeah.
Okay.
That's Aller's turn right there. He's gonna take that focus on that import, so he's gonna stay put.
Holy Kaiser. Will use a legendary action to throw a fist at Alaric. So +16 to hit.
He will try.
Ow!
You take 25 bludgeoning damage and must succeed on a DC 23 constitution saving throw or be stunned. You still have your legendary resistances if you fail and want to just bypass it, which I would suggest. No point in saving those.
Yeah, fuck it. Might as well. I'll burn one of the legendary saves.
Well, see if you pass it first anyway.
You said dex?
Constitution. DC 23.
Oh, okay. I actually not too hateful. Nope. Only one. My bad.
Yeah.
Nat 20.
Yeah, you
didn't even need.
You just you take that slug in the on the jaw like a champ. Hurt though.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Are you going to do a legendary action? You can. Or you can save it for some reason.
Well, I have till my next turn to use, and it just kind of sucks because Alaric technically can only get two, because unless I make three tail attacks, it's either a wing attack or a wing attack, which is two actions, or a tail attack, which is one, so...
Yeah, Kaiser's got Tactical Edge, which costs two actions, but I used it once and it never came up, so it doesn't seem worth it. It is the Incubus' turn. He has already tried to subdue both Elfric and Prize and failed, which means he can't do it again. Man, he is just kind of worthless without, like, that is their main thing. He is going to, he can't go closer to Alaric, so he can get closer to, well, he can't see Prize. He doesn't know what the fuck to do. He loses his turn because he can't, even getting closer to Elfric is technically getting closer to Alaric.
I mean, unless he went, like, back here while he did it and tried to come from behind.
That's a good point. He's got one HP.
A little close to the angels, too, but...
He's got one HP. He's gonna flippy-flap around here in an attempt to attack Elfric with his mirror image, so we need to figure out what mirror image is doing for this.
Mirror image. Three illusory duplicates of yourself appear in the space. Until the spell ends, the duplicates move with you and mimic your actions. Shifting position so it's impossible to track which one is real. Each time a creature targets you with an attack during the spell's duration, roll a d20 to determine whether the attack instead targets one of your duplicates. If you have three duplicates, you must roll a 6 or higher to change the attack's target to a duplicate. With 2, it's 8, and with 3, it's 11. A duplicate's AC equals 10 plus your dex modifier. If the attack hits the duplicate, it's destroyed.
Okay. He has one attack. He doesn't even have multi-attack. He is flapping over to you with this giant arrow in his gut. Little thin boy gut. And he's gonna attempt to swipe at you with his claws. 16. Do you even want to relegate that to one of your things or just
16
take it?
Ties my unarmored AC. So we need to see if he targets. He got a 7 and a 6 or higher will change the attack's target to a duplicate, so I only have 2 duplicates left.
Okay. He did something. He killed one of your duplicates.
Mm-hmm. He should be proud of himself.
Okay. Mirror image, 2 left. That is the end of his turn. Meaning, it is now Holy Kaiser's turn. He gains new regens because no one hit him with Radiant.
Yeah, that's the downside to Alaric's dragon form.
No Radiant.
He's basically, at this point, just a meat shield.
hey, you're stopping Holy Kaiser for going and fucking up your friends. So, he's not going to cast a spell.
No, hit me with a spell.
Well, they're all fire-based.
I bet you won't. You know you want to. Cook this dragon.
And he could use a spell on Elfric, too, if he wanted to.
Hit me. But Elfric is also resistant to fire damage.
You don't know that.
Holy Kaiser does know that.
No, you don't.
Holy Kaiser knows that. Holy Kaiser knows what lurks in Elfric's heart. So he is just going to attack you with Armageddon in his fist.
He will try.
So Armageddon plus 16 to hit.
24.
Yeah. Yeah. And again,
34.
Yep.
Ouch.
And his fist, 24.
Yep.
He, his wrathful gaze pierces you as he raises Armageddon. The golden flail crackles with hellfire. With a deafening roar, he brings the weapon down upon you, bruising you and battering you, while your body doesn't feel the fire. Your very soul feels the burn of this infernal weapon. You feel as though you can feel the grasping claws of devils trying to drag you down to hell. You take... let's head it up.
Whew. Meat shield, don't fail me now.
17 plus 17... Plus,
well, we saw what happens when somebody normally takes that full blunt normally.
Yeah.
With Reagan's weapon.
Normally, you'd be taking well over 100 damage, but you're only taking 59. But you do have to succeed on a DC Constitution saving throw or be stunned.
So I took 59 damage?
59 damage.
And I'm sorry, what roll again?
Constitution saving throw, DC 23.
21.
21, you are stunned. Stunned.
Yeah, I literally searching that too.
Stunned. You are incapacitated. See condition. Okay.
Can't move.
You can't take actions. Yeah, you can't attack either. Can't take actions or reactions. Can't move and can only speak falteringly. You automatically fail.
Attack rolls. No, it says attack rolls against the creature have. Oh, against the creature have. Against me have advantage. Never mind. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So, oof. The power word didn't get you, but his fist sure did.
Cool. Do I get to reroll saves at any point, or just once a turn?
Yep, once a turn.
Can I use a legendary resistance to?
Yes.
Save this. I'm doing that. Fuck. I keep forgetting. I keep forgetting I have those.
Okay.
Yep. Good try.
How many do you have left? It's got to be like one. So I'm pretty sure you used one earlier.
Well,
in the other
day. In the last.
Yeah,
I don't have it marked off, so we'll assume I already used one. So that means after this, I have one left.
Okay. So that is the end of Holy Kaiser's turn. He says, after assaulting you, "How could you be so foolish, Alaric? Did you truly believe, with your limited understanding of this world, you could defeat me?" Like, he says that after he punches you, and, like, you rear back from being punched. but you're able to shake it off, and you hit him back with a zinger of your own.
You act as if you aren't just another pawn for somebody else.
I am the one chosen by the cosmos, and I shall know no defeat. It is now Alexander Balian's turn. How long does protection from good and evil last?
I think it's multiple minutes, which means it'll probably be through this whole encounter. Yeah. Yep, up to 10 minutes. It's concentration, though, so I am concentrating on it.
Okay. Which does mean Terry can't do another spell, right?
I can't do another concentration spell.
Okay. Balian moves to attack the swarm as well. So he gets three attacks. So plus nine with his longsword.
I'm going to do a little icon just so I remember he has concentration going.
And so hits. Hits. And hits. And so total. It's 9 times 3. 21?
9 times 3? That'd be 27.
He is able to cut a swath through these imps, and you guys are slowly whittling their number down. There's just hundreds of them. That is the end of his turn.
Alaric's going to use a legendary action and use his...
Okay.
I'm actually going to spend this one doing three tail attacks. I'm going to try that one, see how that works. So, here's a tail attack against the Kaiser.
You make three tail attacks, or do you just choose one? Oh, you mean, okay, all the way through.
Yeah, I have three legendary actions, so just use all three of them for tail. So I got his AC.
Yep.
And that attack. Thank goodness.
Oh.
At least it's some type of damage. Keep it on. 19 bludgeoning. Have to... 9.
Yep. Okay. Holy Kaiser will respond by punching you in the face. So he uses a legendary action. 20.
That hits.
Is that enough?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So 25 bludgeoning damage and DC 23 constitution saving throw again.
Oof.
You tailed him and he like punched your tail.
24.
Got it. Just barely. Don't have to burn a legendary resistance for it.
Yeah, seriously.
A punch to the tail wasn't as stunning as a punch to the face. But you fucked your tail up.
Ew.
It hoit.
I got a bruise.
It is Prize's turn. And he will... let's see. Does he have any AoE spells? Or anything like that? Steel Wind Strike. I think he's already done that. Yeah, he has. Nope, not really. He's already used up all his lightning arrows. He has Ensnaring Strike he could try and use on the Kaiser.
Yeah, sure, try it.
That would be hilarious. Let me look this up. Yep, Strength Saving Throw. Yeah, why not? So it is a bonus action, so he's going to use his bonus action to cast that spell on his arrow, and he's going to just lob another, like, shoot that and then immediately shoot another arrow at Holy Kaiser. So, I will give him advantage because he is not only hidden, he is behind Holy Kaiser. So he has a plus 12 to hit. He hits with the ensnaring strike. And Holy Kaiser must succeed on a strength saving throw of 17. Well. Holy Kaiser's pretty strong. He's got a plus 8 to strength, actually. Oh yeah, he got it. Okay. Holy Kaiser is not ensnared. The brambles come at him and he easily just rips them apart. And the vines shrivel away. So now it's just a normal attack. So plus 12. 23 hits, and he does 13 damage halved, so 6. So he shoots an arrow, and it hits Holy Kaiser square in the back of his head, a dead center perfect hit. And Holy Kaiser still takes the damage from the first arrow. So, two arrows hit perfectly in the back of Holy Kaiser's head, and they both just, like, either splinter or just, like, fly away. Like, Holy Kaiser just kind of, like, got hit by two softball throws in the back of his head is all he felt. His hair is messed up, though. However, he now has to roll for vanished again against Holy Kaiser. So he has a plus 5 to dex. 10. I do not think that beats Holy Kaiser's passive. No, it is not. Oh, Holy Kaiser knows he's there. Pitiful fool, he says, and lobs a fireball at him. Fireball. He must succeed on a DC 26 saving throw. Oof. He can't. He doesn't have... Well, he can get a 20, I guess. Let's see if he gets a 20. He does not. So he takes the full effect of this fireball. Because he doesn't have anything special. He doesn't have anything special to save him from this hit. So that is 8d6 fire damage. And Prize will take it all. 36.
38.
38. How much? Oh. Well, Prize is still actually doing pretty good. Like, I don't know how he takes his fireball to the face, but somehow he's able to take it like a champ. Maybe he kind of hides behind the mithril throne for a second, but he still takes the fireball. Prize looks about like maybe halfway dead. That's a good way to put it. Yeah, I guess he didn't take it as well as I thought. Never mind. Prize is on fire. It has ignited flammable objects in the area that aren't worn and carried. Okay. It is now Terry's turn.
Okay.
So you still got the imps flapping and clawing at you.
Yeah, I just don't have anything really that's better for the, you know, an area of effect by any means, but... Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and start swinging on these guys. On the
swing
imps.
It. Large skirt.
Attack. 24.
Hit. Oof. Does not. Okay, do the 24 first.
Yeah. Fifteen damage, bless you.
Thank you.
Okay. They get to attack you.
Mm-hmm.
Opportunity attack. So Hyun plus 8 to hit. 1d20 plus 8. 25.
Yeah, that hits.
Hit. You take 26 damage, piercing damage, and must make the DC 11 constitution saving throw. Is there even any way, like, isn't your modifiers after the 9 over that? Isn't it like 14?
What's the, I'm sorry, what saving throw?
Constitution saving throw. Or paralyzed and take more damage, but I don't. Do you even need to roll for that?
I get a 12 modifier.
No, you automatically pass that.
Okay.
The power of your oath, both of your oaths, is more powerful than their venom.
How are these imps looking? Like, is there a shit ton? Like, how many are left? Roughly.
You are surrounded by their dead corpses and exploded bodies. But there's still quite a few of them in the air. It's a little mountain of dead imps. Okay. Their bodies are like covering the charred remains of Alexander, or of Richard Leon and the Kaiser Guards and the various other dead people around you.
Okay.
You're in an area surrounded by dead men.
So that's really all I can do for him. So I'm going to use my second legendary action at the end of his turn and do another tail attack against the Kaiser. God Oof. Dang.
I won't do an opportunity attack. It's a legendary action.
Okay. Dang. Alright.
Because he's going to respond with his own legendary action to punch you in the face. Oh my god!
A swing and a miss.
Yeah, like, you fuck up so bad, it actually, like, shocks him that he fucks up and misses.
Of course.
Like, if your, like, motions had went where you wanted them to, he would have landed with you. But the fact that you, like, fucked up and lost your footing or whatever means that where he thought you were going isn't where you went, and so he stumbled. But it all just washes out. And you both just are like, back at each other.
Oop. Okay. Anyway, so that's it.
The imps will now... Let's see. Balian still has the protection from good and evil. So it doesn't make sense to go for him. So they're just going to keep attacking Terry. Maybe I can kill Terry with imps. 17.
Nope.
I cannot kill Terry with imps. It is now our favorite Fangy Boy Elfric's turn.
Well, Fangy Boy is gonna see that badly wounded incubus coming in, and he's just gonna try to give him a quick slash.
This is when your bats come in and cover you with blood. Yeah, because they took a turn to get here.
So just meow, and I just we're just since he's right by me, is he just soaked in blood?
Too? Oh yeah. If anything, he took like you are covered in less blood than him.
He shielded you a little bit.
Yeah, Archangel Michael laughs at you both. Like that was humorous.
Yeah.
With a snarl, Elfric's just gonna spin around and just try to slash him right across the throat with his rapier.
Go for yeah, it.
Plus 12 to hit, so I got a 16.
16? That hits.
Alright. I am gonna
There is literally go ahead and roll for damage. Let's see how far in the negative you get him, but
1d10 plus 6 and then 2d8 necrotic.
Okay.
1d10 plus.
That's how's it feel to have Elfric back?
It's fucking great. That's 13, and that's not including the 2d8 necrotic. So, 1d8. That's an 8, and 2d8 is a 3. So, 11 plus 13. So, 24.
He is at negative 23.
So Ulfric just spins and just slashes him right across the fucking throat, and he just
drops out of the air.
Smacks into the ground.
Drops out of the air behind the throne. He could not be more dead.
And then Ulfric will use his cunning action to take the dash action so he can go 60 feet. And he's just gonna come down right over here about
oh my god
35 feet away.
Okay. Can you move him?
If you
gotta be on the pointer.
Yeah,
I gotta be on.
I just wanna make sure you can move him.
We'll say right over there. Yep, I can move him.
Okay.
I just don't go on the pointer a lot, and then that'll be Elfric's turn.
Okay, move his little mirror image thing. He's got two left.
Yep.
Okay. It is now Holy Kaiser's last legendary action.
Didn't he use a legendary action on somebody else?
He's used a fireball and a punch.
He used two punches against Alaric. Because you've countered my first two legendary actions with legendary actions.
You have a good point. Okay.
So instead, I'm going to use my third legendary action before it's my turn.
Okay, yeah.
Not enough.
Not enough.
24. So...
That is. Yeah.
I thought 21. He had a 26 AC.
That's the DC for his spells.
Oh my god.
He has a 21 AC.
Oh.
Oop. You want me to make it 26 AC?
Oh, yeah, you're fine.
AC.
I like that number a lot better, actually. Thank you.
He put on a helmet. Like I said, his head is exposed, but he did take two massive shots from Prize straight to the back of the noggin and didn't seem very fazed by it.
21 damage.
21 damage. Taken down to 10. Excellent. Okay.
So that brings me to Alaric's turn?
Yes.
Let's do a recharge, just to know. Oh, I am recharged.
Oh my god.
Is it worth...
Yeah, do it on Kaiser.
Is it worth using the weakening breath, though?
Oh, do you have a different...
I have two.
You have two breaths? What does weakening breath do?
They're gonna succeed a save, or have disadvantage on all strength-based attack rolls, strength checks, and strength saves for 1 minute.
Bro.
So that's pretty good, but then I lose my whole action. But I guess I still have my legendaries. Yeah, you know what?
Bro.
Let's try that. Let's do my weakening breath. So you gotta give me a strength saving throw.
Damn.
See, but I feel like his strength is gonna be pretty fucking good, so... We'll give it a shot, though. It's worth it.
Okay. Well, he only has a plus 8 to strength, so...
Only. God damn. Yeah, so, Alaric excels this, gas, and he just starts, like, hacking on it.
Yeah. So he has a disadvantage on for 1 minute. He can repeat the saving throw at the end of each of his turns. Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, all of his attacks are strength-based.
So strength-based attacks, strength checks, and strength saves for 1 minute. So he has disadvantage on all attacks, so that's going to be spicy.
Yeah, that is not nothing.
Alright, but that's all Alaric can do, so... That's it there.
Okay. Taking it down to Aller's turn.
So, first off, Aller's gonna see if he got his own recharge since he used Mjolnir as a focus. He charges on a 5 or a 6, and he got a 4, so he is not recharged. So is this swarm, is it like 25% with like roughly a quarter of them left, or is it still quite a bit?
25 is a really very close. About 25% of them are left.
Okay.
And you killed about 50 with that spell. 50%.
Yeah, but I can't cast it again because it was through Mjolnir and recharge. I don't have any spells that'll necessarily help with it. But I can. I think it might be about time to actually interfere in that, that fight with Holy Kaiser.
Oh, so yeah. Alaric will take
you approach me.
I'm going to use Misty Step to teleport 30 feet as a bonus action.
Can it be a lightning Misty Step?
Yeah, I think the canon we got for it was that it looks like storm clouds with like lightning pulsing.
Yes.
Yeah, because I think I think we even said that it looks like in Avengers when Thanos is going through those cloudy storm, clouds when he uses that stone.
Well, we're about to get more epic, so I'm still a little bit out of attack range. So
yeah,
I am going to use my action to take the level 20 paladin ability, Avenging Angel. Wings shot from my back and grant me a flying speed of 60 feet. And the first time any enemy creature enters within 30 feet of you or starts its turn there during battle, the creature must succeed on a wisdom saving throw or become frightened of you for 1 minute or until it takes damage. Attack rolls against the frightened creature have advantage. I have a 19 DC for that.
Well, so Kaiser
I'm gonna pop
can't.
That, you're just gonna see these maps. Oh yeah, he can't get intimidated.
Yeah, he can't be frightened.
All right.
Alaric's been trying.
Is that all that does?
It boosts you a little bit, doesn't it?
What's prolong? Wings sprout from your back, flying speed of any speed. Wisdom saving throw. Become frightened of you for 1 minute. It doesn't say it powers you up at all, actually.
Oh. Oops.
Yeah, I would do something else.
You might want to do something else, but... Actually... Do I have... Features and traits?
Andy. Aller.
Yeah.
Aller. You notice... Upon the head of one of the great statues of the... mithril throne is a one-eyed raven. Don't know how it got there.
Ah!
Watches you.
Alright. So, instead of using Avenging Angel, I'm going to use the racial ability, Radiant Soul. Once per long rest as an action, you can transform, gaining glimmering eyes into incorporeal wings. For 1 minute or until you end it as a bonus action, you have a flying speed of 30 feet. And once... go away, thing. I accidentally clicked on something. And once per turn, you can have one attack or spell deal 20 in additional radiant damage to one target.
Oh.
So I okay. that'll be my action, as I'll activate my radiant soul. And you're just going to see another pair of wings, a pair of smaller, slightly less intimidating angel wings than the Avenging Angel. But you're going to see glowing storm cloud.
Yeah.
Glowing storm cloud style wings just appear on his back, and his eyes are going to start glowing. He's just going to glare down at Holy Kaiser, glare up at Holy Kaiser, like, let's fucking go.
I mean, I just imagine he's just giving off big Thor at the end of Ragnarok.
Yeah. Pads. Exactly. And that'll be the end of my turn.
Yeah. That is more than enough to Odin's watching, Aller.
Fuck yeah.
The fate of the world and Terva hangs in the balance, and Norskia's in Terva. Better put that hammer to fucking good use. Let's take a break. Go potty for Holy Kaiser's turn.
Okie dokie.
That seems like a good idea.
Water.
Just like, oh, I just puked.
Oh.
What? Oh yeah, I just puked all over myself. Okay, do you need something? Heather was just like, oh, I just puked.
Oh.
Okay. Oh yeah, I just puked all over myself. Okay, do you need something?
I think the net is beginning to close.
I wonder if that's just a freaking new app. Does he have anything resistance against charmed?
A super high charisma stat. Charisma saving throws are plus 16 without the other aura boost.
All right.
I see.
Gotta pop back.
If you want to try it.
Whew, sorry about that. The kids got done with their bath just as we went on break, so it's like, well, let me help.
No, look.
No, you good.
You are good,
bath
my dude.
Time!
So, with the Celestial Armor of Thor, which I have for having Mjolnir, I'm resistant to all forms of damage other than necrotic, psychic, or null. And I am invulnerable to lightning.
Okay. So, what I'm hearing is, you don't have anything special against being charmed.
Hold on, even with the auras? Hold on, let me...
seeing anything?
Yeah, the auras.
I mean, I have
stop
a plus
him.
16 charisma save, which is what charm goes off of usually, and a plus 14 wisdom.
No.
So I'm not that worried about being charmed.
The auras will make you immune to it. Like, flat out. Let me double check. Aura of devotion. While you are conscious, friendly creatures, including you within 10 feet, can't be charmed. You might have other charms, but at least, well, I guess if you're outside of Terry. Check
your outside of Terry.
Check your auras.
I don't have an aura of devotion.
What auras do you have?
I have... where was the one? Aura Protection, where you are conscious you grant all friendly creatures within you a plus 5 bonus to saving throws.
I have
Aura
that.
Of Courage, while you are conscious, you and friendly creatures within 30 feet can't be frightened.
I have those two, but I also have Devotion. I wonder if that's only for my oath?
Sounds like it. You're not the same oaths.
Yeah, I am Oath of Vengeance.
Still, I feel like you should at least have...
I have a different feature. It's just not an aura from my oath, but it's not an aura. I have the Vow of Enmity instead, which I'm probably going to use fairly soon.
I would... I mean, if there's any doubt, I would really look and see if you had anything against being charmed.
Dude, yeah, I really don't want you to fight a charmed Alar.
Scour that bitch.
Do you have your thing on D&D Beyond?
Yeah, I'm looking at Alar's character sheet on D&D Beyond.
Yeah, because if you
I'm
go
not
to features
finding
and traits,
to prevent me from being...
just go on features and traits, and then scroll down till you start seeing your auras. They should be all listed together. Mine is after the oath spells, after extra attack, and then auras. But it should be before your racial traits. You're a level 20, and I'm only a level 14. I still think you should have more auras.
I have Cleansing Touch, which I could use as an action to end one spell on myself or on one willing creature that I touch 5 times per long res.
I mean, if it's part, like, it's possible he doesn't have the same feats.
It's an action. Yeah, it's an action I can take. I don't have anything that prevents me from.
He's a different subclass.
You need.
Yeah,
still, but...
Oath of Conquest. I am Oath of Vengeance, and Oath of Vengeance is mostly focused.
Do you have anything against, like, making sure people can't be frightened?
I do have Aura of Courage.
That's what I'm saying. Alar has that. Does Terry have that? Like, you can have different things.
I'm telling, I have both of the aura, but okay, so where you see that one aura listed, is there any other auras listed before or after it?
Aura Protection and Aura Courage are the only two auras I have.
That's interesting.
That's all he's got then. Cool. That works for me.
Do you have Vow of Enmity?
No, I don't think so.
Holy Kaiser.
Because I have my Oath of Vengeance.
Since he is weakened, will instead cast a spell. As your eyes light up with lightning, his lights up dark purple with empiric energies. Our make a wisdom saving throw. DC 26.
Alright, I got a plus 14 to wisdom saving throws.
Oh, thank God.
And I rolled a 2. I have a 16. God damn it.
A twisted, jagged crown of thorns.
Fucking crown of madness.
Iron thorn.
You don't have...
Appears on Alar's head.
You don't have any ability to re-roll anything, Andy?
That's what I was asking. He said no.
Even Alaric.
Nothing
has...
I've seen.
Alar.
Share me your character sheet. Let me just triple check. Ahead.
It's the same character sheet on D&D Beyond that you have access to, and I'm not seeing anything.
I don't see it on here. Let me check under the campaigns. Maybe it's hiding in there.
I mean, I'm sure you can change things in it to give it to him.
I found it. It's because I gave him control and, like, authority over it, and I don't have it anymore. But I found it now.
Thank you.
so far. Yeah, because I guess some of the other things that I'm thinking of are fighter traits. And I think that Aura of Devotion is exclusive to the Oath of Devotion that Terry follows, so that makes sense why you don't have that one. But you do have the other two auras, so...
Alar is Charmed, Driven, and Shane. On your turns, you must make a melee attack against a creature other than yourself that Holy Kaiser mentally chooses. The target can act normally on its turn if Holy Kaiser does not designate a target. On Holy Kaiser's subsequent turns, he must use his action to maintain control over the target or the spell ends. Also, the target can make a wisdom saving throw at the end of its turns. On a success, the spell ends.
Did you say Kaiser uses his further actions only to maintain?
Yep.
That's interesting. Okay.
Yep. So, the jagged crown of iron thorns grows upon Alar's head. The lightning in his eyes takes a purple tone, the same as Holy Kaiser's. Alar, you hear the voices of Odin and Thor telling you to kill Jormungandr next to you.
Damn.
Yep. Alar's getting
in his head. In Alar's mind now, Alaric is Jormungandr. A little Jormungandr. Okay. And at the end of Holy Kaiser's turn, he gets to make that strength saving throw. So, its DC was 21. So, he gets a plus 8. Oh, he is still weakened. Ah, see, I mean, that wasn't a bad thing to do.
Interesting.
Okay. It is now... Balin's turn.
Andy, real quick.
He attacks three times.
Look to see if Elfric has any way of just restraining without damaging somebody.
Hitch.
I guess you could damage, but I'm looking for restraining.
Does extra.
Get him.
So that would be... What's 9 times 4?
It's 36.
Yeah, 37.
He is slicing through more and more of these imps. There are very few left. It is Flynn Prize's turn. The absolute mad lad Chad that he is, as soon as I look this up, so he won't use that. He will use Ensnaring Strike on Alar.
Nice, okay.
See? I am not without reason. What do you mean, Ensnaring Strike doesn't...
That's exactly what I was thinking for Elfric. Holding Alar back, but also holding the Kaiser's attention. Tying them both up so everybody can focus fire for a second.
Okay, so he has to make an attack with it, so he's going to use that on Alar, and he will loose the other arrow at the back of Holy Kaiser's head again. Nice. So This is his last use of ensnaring strike. So, he just makes an attack first. He has to get a hit though on Alar. So, he has to get a hit on Alar, and then Alar has to fail a strength saving throw to be ensnared by these vines. 31! Look at him go!
Damn.
So, okay. Alar, you are whacked by this arrow of viney proportions.
You take
6 damage from being halved by the celestial armor.
Alright.
You take 6 piercing, bludgeoning damage, whatever. The arrow doesn't stick in. But the vines come for you. You must succeed on a DC 17 strength saving throw.
And you do not get
plus
Terry's...
Plus 10 to strength.
You don't get Terry's bonus to your saves either.
Yep. I got plus 10 without it.
Uh-oh.
And I rolled an 18.
Alright.
He is not restrained. He tried. He tried. Okay, other...
You still take damage, though?
Oh, yeah. Alar took damage. 6. He took 6 whole damage.
Does Tink. 6 shake me out... To have a chance of shaking me out of the charm person?
It doesn't...
I think
it's not
only
yeah. There's nothing
turns that you can read.
Yeah, other charms are like that, but this is specific to Crown of Madness. The only way it ends is if Holy Kaiser fails or you succeed. So other one is going for Holy Kaiser back of his head. He has advantage because he's attacking from behind. He already hit, but
nice.
Okay. Holy Kaiser takes 6 damage. Again. Whack! Back of the head. Arrow goes flying. And Holy Kaiser responds again. By lobbing a fireball at him.
Can he do legendary actions if his actions are...
I knew that was coming.
just asking.
It doesn't say anything about legendary actions. It only says on your subsequent turns, you must use your action to maintain control over the target. It doesn't say anything about, like, other actions, so I assume they're unaffected.
Hmm. Okay.
So, because this spell is actually pulled from what I based Holy Kaiser's model on, his stat block. Mm-hmm. So this is, like, there is a, like, base D&D big bad evil guy that uses Crown of Madness and who has legendary actions, and Crown of Madness doesn't say anything about him. So, but yeah, I knew that was coming. So,
gotta ask.
Oh yeah, he's got to do a dex saving throw plus 5. Got to get above 26, which I guess he can't. I guess he could still. He almost rolled a 20. But he doesn't, so he takes a full 5. Come on, show me fireball. 8d6. Holy Kaiser sees him up there. That sneaky little goose. 28.
Just to be sure, I lapsed. Did you give him disadvantage on that attack roll?
What attack roll?
Well, no, yeah.
The strength saving throw? Or the strength rolls? He's just lobbing a fireball.
Yeah, you're right. My bad.
He doesn't do that by strength. Okay, so he takes 28 damage. Flynn Prize is... still fairly okay. He's getting closer to death.
He's getting rocked.
If he's taking more of these fireballs, he's not going to be in a good place. But, god damn it, he is still in it. What a Chad. It's Terry's turn.
Fury. He's really just sick of this fucking swarm. But the hold up with him is he doesn't have many other options other than close range combat. So, like, he would. He was considering breaking away and helping, but then he's got to get up in Kaiser's face. So I guess he's just going to keep swinging at this swarm and try to give him and Balian some relief back here.
Yeah, because then you'd be leaving Balian.
Yeah. Well, I was considering it before Aller left, but now that he did, honestly, I need to stick it out anyway.
Good enough.
And one more. Oof.
They're not.
Wasted a turn.
Now that there's fewer of them, they're harder to hit.
Well, that's all I got, so.
It is their turn. And they attack you. Terry.
They're gonna rock me.
Potentially. 11.
Ooh, okay, miss.
Okay. It is Elfric's turn.
Elfric's turn. Alright,
So Elfric doesn't have a viable way of actually stopping this. Of stopping what's happening with,
You could grapple him.
I could try to grapple him, but that's
He may be the son of Thor, but you're the Eternal Emperor.
That is true.
It's payback for him smiting you that one time.
Yeah, see? Just give him a big old hug. I'm sure it'll work out great for you. Not like he's... you know. Son of Thor. Wielding Mjolnir.
Yeah, Elfric just does not have the kind of spells that he needs for this. So...
If you kill Holy Kaiser, the spell ends. Or if you incapacitate... If you can give Holy Kaiser a status effect, spell ends. Like, if he's... You know, stunned, grappled, maybe not grappled. We'd see about grappled, but, like, any of the big ones. His body may be weak, but his mind has never faltered.
So Elfric is going to cast a spell centered on Holy Kaiser. He's going to cast Fog Cloud. And just create a nice 20-foot radius of fog centered on Holy Kaiser.
Okay.
Okay.
And it lasts up to an hour. So that's going to be his
action. What? That is what the Eternal Elfric does.
He inked.
He made a cloud.
Elfric still got his... He's got his movement speed, so he's going to move 30 feet, which puts him about here. And then he's going to use his cunning action as a bonus action to take the hide action.
Hide behind him.
Okay. Do a stealth check.
Alright. I got... Plus 16 to stealth.
Yeah. What's the radius on the smoke cloud, and I'll just put it on Holy Kaiser?
It's a 20-foot radius. So 28, and then I'm in the fog, so I should have advantage, right?
Oh, yeah.
It'd be a 40-foot
so
circle.
We got a 28 for the first one, and a 26 for the second.
Oh yeah, you are hidden. Well, actually, his His passive perception is 26, so you beat it. Just barely.
Yeah.
He sees all, but not when there's a bunch of smoke in his face.
Yep, I'm invisible now, and that cost me everything I could do this turn, so, yeah, it's, the end of Elfric's turn.
I will say he does need sight to cast Crown of Madness, but there's no doubt that he needs it to keep it going.
Well, at the very least, Aller can't see either, and therefore Aller is at a disadvantage.
Fair point.
And Elfric is not at disadvantage because Elfric should have blind sense from his rogue abilities. So.
And so does Alaric.
Yeah, blind sense.
Yeah, Holy Kaiser, he doesn't have anything like that.
Yeah, so, wow, that's interesting that Alaric in dragon form and Elfric can actually still see through this, and we aren't disadvantaged. Huh. Okay.
I hate to break... Okay, yeah. I'll keep it to myself.
He has true sight, doesn't he?
He has a vision of the one true God. That's all he needs.
Alright, anything else for you?
Okay. The wording I used for vision of the one true God is magical darkness does not impede Holy Kaiser's dark vision.
This isn't darkness.
Okay.
It's fog cloud.
And blind sight literally works by like sound and feeling. So
he's got echolocation.
I have blind sight, so I just have echolocation to fight them. Wow.
Holy Kaiser only has dark vision, but he's got the thing that magical darkness doesn't impede it.
Yeah, but this isn't magical darkness. So
this is not but like
technically,
could you see what I could have possibly been like anticipating with that?
Yeah,
the spell darkness.
100%.
That Elfric loves to fucking do.
Elfric doesn't have the spell darkness.
That's funny.
Yeah, that was one of the... I mean... Okay, I thought you took it as, like, an actual spell.
No, I don't have the darkness spell.
You can do all vampire spells. Can't vampires cast
Vampires
darkness?
Get fog cloud. I don't know if he gets, it wasn't on the list that's written down so far. But I haven't changed his spells out either yet, so it wasn't on the default list.
Yeah, actually, no. Vampires don't get... Okay. Yeah, okay, well, never mind, because that was a feat given to Elfric by Asmodeus.
Yeah.
Asmodeus took away.
Yeah, he had this ultimate darkness spell.
As you are too bad of a boy. And
yep.
Papa Asmodeus took it away.
But
okay,
still got fog cloud, though.
If anyone tried to use darkness on Holy Kaiser, he'd see him, but not... through just normal fucking fog.
Yeah.
Yep. Just don't flap your wings, Trey. We can keep this fog around, and that'll be nice.
Okay. Interesting. Alright.
It is... Unless Elfric's got anything left, it is...
Nope, Elfric's out. He used his bonus action at everything.
It is... Alaric's turn. You got it.
Dope. I'm going to start making my attacks. I'm going to go in for a claw.
Go for it.
24.
I picked like the most epic moment for, like most epic music for this, but go for it.
I'm going to go in for the second one. 33. Going in for the big old bite. God damn it.
You missed.
Do I have advantage that he can't see and I can?
Yeah. Yeah, legitimately.
26. Okay.
Go ahead and do two more rolls, see if you get a critical on any of them.
Okay. 33 for the first.
Nope. Okay, all of them hit.
Hell yeah. Okay, we'll do the claws first. That is 2, 6, 8, 16. 16! So that's... What? 32?
32? Yep,
32. And bite which is a little bit more beefy. And a third 16.
Okay.
48 damage total.
Okay.
No one else is around for that, so... Yeah. You know what? Real quick, just roll for my breath. Nope.
All right. Yeah, don't worry. Forget that.
I think I'm done.
Okay. Aller, Jormungandr was right next to you, and he poofed. It's pure...
It's Loki trickery.
It's Loki trickery.
The Loki serpent trickery. Has disappeared into the smoke.
That dragon... Snake.
So, Aller's gonna do a perception check, see if he can find anything?
I mean, he is giant and right next to him. Like,
okay. So Aller's just gonna swing and be like, I know roughly where he's at.
Yes.
But you attack with disadvantage.
Alright,
Yes. Plus Aller doesn't have, like, true sight or anything?
Not as far as I know. Nothing okay. I can see for it.
Alright.
So Aller's gonna have a plus 11 to hit with Mjolnir. And he's gonna have two attacks, so he crit fails the first one. That was with disadvantage, so crit fail on the first one, we'll see the second one. Second one, he got a 19.
19 is my AC.
So he hit one.
Okay. Well, with that crit, or that fail, critical fail, which was your first attack, Aller wildly swung in his rage at seeing Jormungandr next to him and wanting to protect his papa. he has opened himself up to an opportunity attack from Alaric.
Can I... I don't even want to attack him, but is it possible that I just, like, instead try to nudge him so he's, like, not facing me anymore?
You could attempt a...
Which is, like, push him, or...
You could attempt a contest of strength with an advantage against him.
And then if I succeed, just have him, like, redirected?
Well, I don't know how you could fully just redirect him if he, like, feels you, if he'll know where you are. But, I'm saying if you wanted to try and grapple him, one of your giant meaty claws,
you know what? I will do that. I'm going to, I'll do a contest of strength and try to grapple him.
Okay. Alaric has advantage. So both of you do strength checks.
Oof.
Glad you got that.
19.
Advantage.
Yeah.
Oh! The plot thickens! Roll again, both of you.
We'll do it again.
The struggle is real.
16.
Oh! 23. Aller is grappled in the giant, meaty claws of Alaric, but Alaric tries everything he can not to cut him with his claws.
Yeah, just so got him grappled.
You got him grappled in one of your claws.
Perfect.
So, Aller, that is the rest of your turn, because you are now grappled. However, you get to make another wisdom saving throw against Crown of Madness, DC 26.
Plus 14...
Nope. You are still charmed.
Well, at least you're not going to be hurting me.
Yeah, that... See, it's working out for you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we are back to Holy Kaiser's turn.
We are back to Holy Kaiser's turn. Aww.
Unless he's using his whole action to just keep... Aller passive, or controlled.
He sure is. So, he spends his turn maintaining control over the target. So, the only thing he gets to do is do another strength saving throw against the weakening breath, DC 21. Man, he cannot. Ooh. He can't get out of it, and that's like really making it pretty worthless for him to. Which I haven't had him even try a punch recently, but. Still, probably because it. he doesn't want to swing and miss. That wouldn't look godly.
See, but that's kind of pretty cool that instead he's just kind of choosing to like just stand there and like try to figure out what's going on.
Yeah,
he sees honestly, the shadows of Alaric and Aller fighting in front of him, but he can't really tell what's going on.
And he doesn't know Elfric's behind him, that evil little bastard.
I bet he suspects however, he's coming, but he doesn't know.
He did not pick Radiant. So that is the end of Holy Kaiser's turn. It is Alexander Balian's turn.
Alaric's gonna use a legendary action to use a tail attack against the Kaiser.
Do it.
So
you
sorry.
Have advantage because Holy Kaiser can't see you.
I'm like, wait, it's been a turn.
Oh.
Did lordy, he just get a 20?
Did yes, this I did this fog did Elfric inking just change the flow of this whole battle?
Yeah, holy
fate no. of the world rests on Elfric just being like, fuck clap.
We just made the fun of you so hard when you did it. It's like hell. Holy hell.
I think it's mostly just that both him and Alaric can still see through it. Okay.
Sorry, so 8 and...
Full cloud is a good spot.
5. That's 13, doubled, so 26 plus 8, so 34 damage.
Okay.
So, sorry. Okay, so Balian's turn.
Snuck a tail whip in there. Balian will attack the thingies, so he gets a plus 9.
From Balian and Terry's perspective, they just see, like, a, like, dragon, like, tail and wings just flapping.
Oh,
tail
comes oh yeah. Alaric is big enough that, like, there are parts of him outside of the,
He basically just looks like he's, like, shoved, like, his head and, like, upper body in there. What's going on here?
Crit.
Ooh.
And another one. Is it?
Can he do it?
What was 9 times 4 again?
36.
Oh.
36, yeah.
Balian has killed all but one imp. One imp remains.
God damn.
And it hisses.
Have prize
it is
shooter.
Now prize's turn. Yeah, I just might.
Because, I mean, Kaiser, he would have disadvantage trying to hit Kaiser.
Yeah. Yeah, so prize, he draws his bow and aims at this one stupid fucking imp and launches 2 arrows at it. Hits. And hits. And deals a total of 26 damage. The imp has 2 arrows shoot right in its head and fall over. The imp swarm is now a giant mountain of little corpses.
Oh. I just imagine Terry and Bailey and just like look over their shoulder and they all just kind of like 3-way nod at each other.
This is just the further cemented. One, how much everybody fucking hates imps. and two, how good of a fucking shot Prize is. It's like,
hell
when,
yeah.
he, when like, Alaric, when you came back to the south and everybody was like, yo, Alexander Balian, Wolfgang Regenstoffen, and
the Lion.
And Flynn Prize. Like,
yeah, they got Richard,
they're the
too.
Best. And then you're like, dude, I've seen elves. Have you seen an elf fire a bow? This dude can't be better than elves. I mean, bro ain't missed a shot.
No, he's been, like, S tier. Let's just say, just if we all make it through this, Prize and Balian are getting one hell of a promotion.
Even though he'll be at a disadvantage, Holy Kaiser will do a legendary action to swing wildly at Alaric.
So, yeah, that... Oh, wait.
28.
Yeah, that still hits.
Yeah, even Kaiser at a disadvantage is still pretty tough. 25... bludgeoning damage, and you need to do the roll to see if you get stunned.
Whew. Okay, what's that roll?
DC 23? Yes, DC 23 Constitution saving throw.
God dang it, 21.
Okay.
Last legendary resistance. I'm using my burn, my last one.
Okay.
That stun is no fucking joke right now.
Yeah, I mean, I would assume that would mean that you would let go of Aller. Like,
would it?
It's, I mean, stun makes it sound like you seem absolutely worthless.
Yeah, pretty
stunned
much.
Stunned really is like one of the harshest fucking, like, it doesn't, like, you hear stunned and it's like, oh, you're dazed. Like, no, stunned is
incapacitated.
Yeah.
Alaric's gonna use Terry, a legendary sir. Action to use another tail okay. attack. 30, but why not? Let's do another. Okay, 30.
The 30 hits.
Seventeen damage.
Okay.
Okay. Terry's going to, at least seeing Alaric engaging, you know, what's going on, I'm gonna run in here, and I at least knew Aller was in here trying to attack Alaric, so I'm gonna run under Alaric's wing here.
Okay. Fair enough.
Gage. Okay, well, he's at least grappled. But...
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you're hunting for Aller. So...
Yeah, I'm hunting for
ahead.
Aller.
Like, I won't do it with any disadvantage or anything, but roll for insight. Or something like a check that would help him find Aller. Like, I think insight is probably the best one, especially since you had, like, Terry had his back turned to this.
Okay.
But, I didn't give you a DC. Okay, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like, at the very least, it was going to be 10. Okay. You do not find Aller in the fog. Like, wherever he is, you, like, Terry just strolls right past it.
Okay. Well, I at least used my movement, got up there. Can't really do anything. But
let's, okay. Roll another insight to see if you know when to stop before you could become face to face with Holy Kaiser.
Well, that's his full movement.
Oh, that's his, okay.
Yeah, it was, cool. I think 30 feet was that before.
He dashes!
Yeah, just about. Well,
yeah, that extra five.
Okay.
I'm not worried about it.
So let me just see. in other context, see what else I can do. Real talk, I should probably... Yeah, I'm gonna heal myself up, actually.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna heal myself up. That's... gonna help a lot. Help a bit. And let me just make sure there's nothing else I can do for a bonus that would help. Dang, all of those are concentration. Oh, except Sanctuary. Hold up, hold up. Okay, cool. Yeah, actually, would you say Terry can still, at this point, make out Alaric?
Yeah, like...
Okay.
Because Alaric and Aller are kind of, like, struggling, and so, like, Alaric is not just being, like, still. Like, So, like, the wing is, like, moving over Terry and shit like that. He can definitely draw where Alaric is, for sure.
Okay, cool. Well, he's going to, with a bonus action, cast Sanctuary on Alaric, because it isn't concentration, so he can still maintain his thing over Balian. that just makes it, any creature who targets the warded creature, Alaric, with an attack or harmful spell must first make a wisdom save. On a failed save, the creature must choose a new target or lose the attack or spell.
Okay.
Yeah, so, I'm gonna put a little icon, I guess, on Alaric, just to remind me.
I mean, Alaric's... It'll be way off to the right since his model thing's so huge.
Yeah, you're not wrong. But that should be all Terry can do, but at least he's close, but not right up in Kaiser's grill.
Okay. Holy Kaiser will, if that's the end of his turn, do another legendary action punch. So... he has disadvantage, but so he has to do a... must first make a wisdom saving throw. So, what's the saving throw? What's the DC?
On what? I'm sorry?
This sanctuary.
There is no saving throw.
There is.
Oh, I'm sorry, a wisdom saving throw. His save would be in spells 17.
Okay. Holy Kaiser gets a... has a wisdom. Yeah, wisdom. He has a plus 8. Thirteen.
So he has to be able to attack somebody else or he can't attack.
Okay. He wastes that legendary action because there's no one around that he knows to attack.
Alright. Alaric will use his last legendary action to do his third tail attack.
Okay.
Oh, boy. Feels good, man.
All we needed was a little bit of fog.
9 doubled to 18 plus 8 would be 26 damage.
Okay.
Alright. That's his last legendary.
So it is now.
I'm excited to see what you have cooked up for Elfric now. This worked a lot better than I thought it was going to.
Well, it's Elfric's turn. You are hidden.
Elfric's gonna stab him in the back with his rapier. Plus 12 to hit and with advantage.
He's getting that sneak attack in.
I got a 21.
21 just hits.
21 hits, so I do the damage from my rapier, which is...
He gets it just in the plate.
1d6, or, yeah, 1d10 plus 6, so 1d10.
There is no chinks in the plate, so he has to be going for the head.
6, yeah, I just stabbed him in the back of the head.
Like,
1d10 plus 6 from the rapier, that is 7, plus 2d8 necrotic, so d8, 2 necrotic.
Okay.
So here comes the 2d8 necrotic. That's another 9. Then I get my sneak attack dice, which is 9d6.
Oh yeah, that's where it's going to come from.
No, that's not all the tech.
It's not all the tech.
All right. So that's 35. Now that activates my level 17 rogue ability. Let's see, which page was it on again? There's too many papers in this packet. Oh, wait, no, I had it right. No, it's not that one. Is it this one? Oh, yeah, there it is. Death Strike. Starting at 17th level, you become a master of instant death. When you attack and hit a creature that is surprised, which I would say you're pretty surprised, it must make a constitution saving throw. DC 8 plus dex plus proficiency bonus, which adds up to 17. On a failed save, double the damage of your attack against the creature. So roll that DC 17 con save.
Okay, he has a plus 9 to con. 24.
Okay, so he doesn't double the damage, but he gets 35.
Good, almost. Okay.
35 plus 7 plus 9, so 7 and 9 is...
What was the necrotic damage? Because that's halved.
That was 9.
The necrotic was the 9, so that'd be the 5.
Everything else he'll take the full damage from because your rapier is a magical weapon.
So 7 plus 5 plus 35, so 47 damage.
Actually, you know what? You do stab through a chink in the mithril armor. The mithril armor has been pierced. He exclaims in pain. For the first time in the entire battle... He exclaims in pain.
Alright, and then Elfric is going to use his cunning action to... he's going to move over here with his movement, and then he's going to take the hide action again.
Okay, roll a... well, I mean, it's the fog and everything, too,
Plus 16 to stealth, and I have advantage.
Okay, his passive perception is 26, so I guess there is still a chance. You have advantage.
16. Expertise is a nice thing. That's a 26 for the first roll, and a 20 for the second.
The 26 makes it. You are still hidden.
Yep.
Oh, he knows it was you. who managed to pierce the mithril armor. The mithril plate.
Yeah, when I stab him and I feel my blade go through, I figure he cackles a little bit behind him, then jumps back and disengages the hide.
You don't whisper anything in his ear?
No, he just let out a little mischievous cackle and then just ducks off to the side.
Okay, actually, since you are like stabbing him in like the side and the back, Christopher, who was it, Lloyd? Who did Saruman?
Christopher Lee?
Christopher Lee specifically said that people do not scream when they're stabbed in the back. They, like, gasp. They go, yeah. So that is what he does. It's a sound that Elfric is very familiar with. So he knows he got him.
And lets out his mad little cackle and disappears into the fog.
Elf and Holy Kaiser is astonished. He screams at the fog. You are nothing but a scourge upon this land. I will not rest until you and every one of your kind is dead. I swear upon this hammer that I will not be defeated by the likes of you. He is just like thrashing around, screaming to everyone. Like
Elfric's going to respond to that with a, you got to find me first.
Oh, you're fucking making him even more mad. He seethes and screams, Armageddon shall know no rest until you fall. I shall know no peace until your kind is eradicated from the world. I swear I shall be the one to send you back to Asmodeus, broken and screaming. If somebody didn't know where Holy Kaiser was, they know where he is now. He screamed that at the top of his lungs. And his voice was, like, terrifying, like, booming, like, horrifying. Like, he's just been, like, even when he's, like, raised his voice, it's always just been an authoritative, like, and that has been enough to instill, like, some fear in even, like, Alaric in dragon form. This was him, pure, unfiltered rage, screaming. And it was intense. He would definitely use his last legendary action to try and find you, to punch you, but I guess since you're hidden, there wouldn't even be a chance to hit you.
Yep.
So he just wildly flails at where you were, but that's all he can do.
You guys laughed when I cast Fog Cloud, and look what happened. Elfric strolled in and just gave him a quick stab. Just gave him a nice little poke.
Okay. It is Alaric's turn. Game.
All right, I'm just gonna start with my claws. Oldie buddy goody. Well, claw.
Oldie buddy goody.
I got Aller in my other hand.
Yeah. Got a fa fa.
If 17 on the first.
You have advantage because he doesn't see you.
32 so, on the first.
Yeah. Nope. Oh, just the first.
On the second. And coming in with the bite.
Oh my god. Every time you've gotten a critical against him.
Thank goodness. Your boy can use it. Alright, first claw damage that hits is 18. And the bite damage, 13 doubled is 26 plus 8. So, 34 damage on the bite.
Okay, so that will be... Yes. Also, another thing to add to Elfric's thing is when he appeared beside him to stab him, he also has the mirror images, so, like, the other two Elfrics appeared around him. So, like, yeah. He didn't even know which one was the real Elfric to, like, swing at.
He just saw three Elfrics, and then there was, for a brief second, and then there was pain.
There was intense pain in his back. Oof. That's amazing.
Alright, well, I think that's really all. Wait, and my breath?
Yep.
There it is. Got a breath recharge, so just in case you break out of your weakness, I got you again.
Damn, this... Okay. However, it is now Aller's turn. Do that. Try and get out, my dude.
All right, so I got to get out.
You're in the coil. You've been coiled by Jormungandr here.
So I got a D20 plus 5 for the modifier to try and strength my way out of this. I got a 9. I don't think I'm strengthening my way out of this. I'm going to roll to see if Mjolnir recharges as well while I'm thinking about it. I got a 5. Mjolnir's recharged.
Okay, well, Trey still got to roll against your... So roll against his 9 for strength.
Oh, duh, yeah, my bad.
No, you're fine.
No, you're good.
Yeah, he is still grappled.
And now I roll to see if I break out of the crown, which is a... I got a 24.
Wisdom.
Nope. So, Aller does nothing.
Yeah, damn.
Hey, but at least you didn't hurt me.
Yeah, actually, this grapple has been, like, because, I mean, could you imagine Aller going just ham?
Yeah.
That was the plan. That was the plan.
Man, I was charging up for my big attack. I was going to do my Vow of Enmity next. Get permanent advantage for the next minute on Holy Kaiser.
Mm. You're in Terry's aura now, so is that 14 even more?
Yeah, that would give me another +4, so that'd be a 28.
Well, unless you're not an ally and Terry doesn't want to give you his aura.
Are you going to give me my aura, your aura? You don't know where I'm at. You can't deselect me.
You can't deselect me.
But if I know you were fighting Alaric, and you would turn for a minute, Alaric's going
to
use a legendary.
Out, so with my intention. To okay. Your ally.
I'm sorry. To get out of the thingy.
Wisdom. Yeah.
Oh, so now you want to do it? It's in your favor.
I mean, I don't know. It's up to you guys.
Give me a 28, or do you want me to stick with 24?
I mean, if we have already established that Terry knows that Aller is under someone else's control and trying to break free of it, I don't see why Terry would. Aura from him.
That's fair.
Even though it's not just when it suits him. But.
Okay. Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, take your aura.
Okay.
You get a +4.
You are no longer under the control of Holy Kaiser. The spell is broken.
So Aller's just shaking his head like, God. Oh, why am I on the floor?
I mean, Jormungandr just turns back into Alaric in front of you.
Oh, and that's not supposed to happen. So Aller is free. He'll try it. That pretty much cost him his entire turn, I'm assuming.
Yeah, you're still grappled. He has to let go of you.
Yeah, so Aller will just end his turn then.
Legendary action, I'm using a tail attacking as the Kaiser.
Okay. You have advantage.
26.
You succeed.
The only way we can do it at this point is just whittling him down. 14 damage. Alright.
It is Holy Kaiser's turn, and he is... not happy.
Just try to find Elfric. He pissed you off.
Oh, he is very mad at Elfric. First he is going to attempt to... get out of the fog cloud. So, that will obviously open himself up to an opportunity attack from both Elfric and Alaric. If either one goes off, he is not able to escape, but he can still attack. So, that is also a warning that if you stop him, he will certainly have a better idea of where you are. Okay, now that we've covered all the bases. He has a movement speed of 30. So, you guys, he is attempting to walk. Like,
Elfric's taking that opportunity attack if he gets the option.
So is Alaric. You have advantage.
16 you succeed. On a bite.
All right. And here comes. I'll throw down both of Elfric's real quick. That's an 18, and that's a 26.
You both hit.
I don't think he's going anywhere.
Yeah, so just do your damage for both of your attacks.
Do I get a sneak attack off of the opportunity attack? Because it is by surprise.
It is by surprise, and unless there's something saying that you don't get it for opportunity attacks, I'm going to have to say yes.
That's 18 from Alaric.
Okay.
I will double... Once per turn, you can deal an extra 96 damage to what creature? It says once per turn, since this isn't a turn.
Yeah.
So it'd just be my...
If you hadn't had done it earlier, like, because this is, like, still remaining from the last turn.
That's true.
Yeah. So, if you hadn't have done it on your turn of this round, then yeah, but since you did, it's just a normal attack then.
But Death Strike just happens when I hit.
Okay, Death Strike just happens when you hit. So what, go ahead and roll for damage, and then I'll do the Death Strike thing.
Alright, so that's a D10 plus 6. So that's 14, and then I get 2d8.
So he takes the full 14.
And he'll take half of this. That's 9, so 5 again.
Okay. And then what was it?
Death Strike, he has to make a 17 con throw or all damage is doubled.
Okay, he's got a plus 9 to con.
Okay. He got it.
Okay. That time, I don't think that attack was strong enough to get through the mithril plate, but maybe you sliced his other cheek from behind.
Yeah, I just put a quick slash on it right across his face.
Oh, and he is not happy about that. However, I will say that does expose you.
Mm-hmm.
You do have your two mirror images, so it's not like you are still obscured by the fog, so he has a disadvantage, but he knows where you are, or
I'm not hidden. He has a general idea of my
Yeah, son. Same with where Alaric is. So, he is going to swing Armageddon at both of you, and then a punch at Elfric. So
that's not nice.
We'll throw the one Armageddon swing at Alaric first with disadvantage. 32.
He hit.
It's 23, but yeah.
So you take 17 bludgeoning damage, but no fire damage.
Oof.
I have resistance to fire. I didn't think I had immunity.
Okay, yep. So he attacks Elfric with disadvantage. 24 with Armageddon.
Yeah, that hits.
So he then will smash you with a attempted fist. So 18.
18 hits.
So you take 17 bludgeoning damage, you take half of 36 fire damage, and you take 25 bludgeoning damage.
17, 18, and 25.
Yep. And then you must succeed on a DC 23 Constitution saving throw or be stunned.
That's 60 points of damage.
Yes.
God.
And then
damn.
What was the save?
23 Constitution saving throw. He says, "You foul monster, you dare still stand against me." You feel the pull of hell. You feel that should you submit to these wounds, that no other afterlife could touch you.
I got a
and your soul is claimed by hell.
I got a
That's
24 by the saving throw.
24. Okay, you succeed. But yeah, Alaric, with each attack of Armageddon, you feel like hell has a claim on your soul.
Jesus.
Hell already has a hell claim on Elfric's soul, so he's used to this feeling. But you feel like should you submit to these wounds, no other afterlife could claim you. You will go straight to hell.
Lovely. And that's where we'll kill Asmodeus. We're gonna
like
break out of hell.
Like, I didn't hear no fucking bell. That is the end of Holy Kaiser's turn. You guys want to do one more round all the way through, or what do you think?
Let's do one more wrap up. Try to wrap up here, and
because they are kind of going rapid fire now.
Yeah.
But looking at Holy Kaiser, you like. It's not being decided tonight unless you guys like pull out a nuke out of your hands or something.
We can do one
Which,
more.
I mean, Aller's free now, so
Aller is free now. That has some serious potential.
I'm gonna use a second legendary action and attack that Kaiser with a tail.
Okay.
Oh, 18.
That's a negative
Still
Ghost
misses.
Rider.
All right. Balian.
Balian can move 30. Don't know why I'm looking at it. Yeah, he can move 30. So, he will move up here. He charges into the fog. Zero shits given. He will find Holy Kaiser. He says, "I didn't hear no fucking bell." Yeah, that is all he can do is move up there.
Hey, he can always just hold an action. If the Kaiser
to
comes
dash.
Oh, he did. No, he can.
No.
He can... Did he dash all the way up there?
No.
He can technically hold an action that, like, if he does see the Kaiser and he gets in range, he can attack.
Okay, yeah. If Holy Kaiser comes within 5 feet of him and he happens... Like, he'll have to do a perception check. If he sees him, he'll be able to attack him.
Sure.
Prize. Can't see into this fucking fog cloud. Oh. When a ranger attacks a creature they can't see, their inability to see it doesn't impose a disadvantage on the roll. The target is the ranger is always aware of the location of any invisible creature within 30 feet. He just knows where he is somehow.
He's been tracking him.
His ranger
yeah.
senses.
Like, he's like, I know he hasn't moved from that fucking spot. So... Yeah, he is going to lob to... He's used basically all of his spells other than Pass Without Trace, which I don't think that's going to come up. So he is just going to shoot at Holy Kaiser's location with his longbow. So 15 does not hit. 23 does, and so Holy Kaiser... takes 13, split in half, so 6. Just another funk. Like, still, even in the fog, a perfect shot. on the second one. The first one missed. But his first miss of the night, and it was into just a fucking cloud of fog where he thinks Holy Kaiser is, and the second one still managed to hit directly in the back of the head.
Still pretty good.
It is now Terry's turn. Terry, you got the tyrant in front of you.
But Terry can't see through this.
Terry cannot. I will say, even though you don't know specifically where the Kaiser is, like, you can kind of, like, get a gauge of it based off of where Alaric is attacking. Like,
okay, so that would at least let me get closer and make an attack with disadvantage against the Kaiser.
Yeah, you know his general direction, but you're still kind of fumbling in the fog.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to, with a bonus, this is going to
drop. How long does fog cloud last?
Fog cloud could last like up to an hour.
Is going to drop it off of Bailey.
And yeah, up to an hour, or until a wind of 10 mile per hour or greater disperses. Wow. It.
Okay.
I'm going to use Branding Smite, which lights my hammer up with a radiant light, and I'm going to go in and make my attacks against the Kaiser.
Okay, do it.
Oh, oops, I've been rolling the wrong thing to hit on him. Well, I got a 17. Miss. Let me try again. 18. Nope. Wasted.
Okay. Holy Kaiser. Let me see. A creature that damaged you, so he can't do that hellish rebuke. But I will have him burn a whole legendary action to tell Terry that his family still lives. Terry Brothblood, he says, like avoiding your hammer blows. Like, just like see this, like, whoom, he's like, I recognize that hammer. He says, Terry Brothblood, you think you have nothing to fight for, but you couldn't be further from the truth. No harm has come to your family. Wouldn't you like it to stay that way? Are you not the Inquisitor, the icon of mercy? How could you say that if you have no mercy for your own family?
Terry just roars in anger and, like, makes that second attack, which misses.
Okay. You know what? You know what? I like, we're doing it. It's an intimidation contest. So I don't care what you want to use to roll against it. His fury, his wisdom, like, whatever. But Holy Kaiser, he's getting an intimidation for that. I've been sitting on that one. Just haven't had a good time to use it because Terry's been in the back. But, like, you're in his grill now. And he didn't throw away those assets yet. Okay, he's got a plus 10 to intimidation.
Yeah, I can't. I have nothing that can get that high.
Okay. I don't know, Terry. How do you feel about that? Can't be good. You see the faces of your family. Because Terry's got a pretty big... The Brothblood clan was pretty large, and that was his biggest, like, hold-up on, like, why it took him so long to betray Luther, is because, the, you know, the knowledge that, well, if I betray the Reich, obviously my family's going to die. But now, to hear Holy Kaiser say that his family's alive, and that their lives hinge on what he does here, I don't know. That could be a turn right there. Your turn's over, and this is the last round of the game tonight, so there'll be plenty of time to think about the ramifications of this. Because he... Why don't you go ahead and roll? Let's see how bad you lost that. Like, you can do Constitution or any modifier you want to add to that. Okay, you added 4. What was that from?
Intimidation. There's nothing. Unless I'm doing...
You're intimidating... you're intimidating it back by screaming?
I mean, you said it was a contest, but I don't have anything else that could even... Other than insight, medicine, or persuasion, I have nothing else that would be more beneficial to contest it with.
I mean, insight, like, would be that to know that they are being held as leverage against him, and that, like, that the insight could be that Holy Kaiser could probably just be fucking lying, and that they're already dead. Like, there's, like, it's the weight of the possibility of his family being alive to betraying, you know, Alaric and everyone. But again, Terry did lose, so something to sit on for a little while. And he lost by a lot. Okay. It is Elfric's turn. Elfric, you've got him completely hidden. He don't see you.
So
actually, no, you're not. You're not hidden.
Yeah,
you were revealed.
I was revealed with the. But
you were revealed,
he,
but there's 3 of you.
Is, yeah, so I can disengage without having to worry about provoking an opportunity attack, right? Like, I can move
yes.
out of there. All right.
I think, isn't hiding a bonus action anyway?
Hiding is a full action, but I can use it as a bonus action because of my cunning action.
So you can hide before you attack.
As a bonus action. Well, actually, I'm not going to attack at all. I'm going to move over here.
Okay, bye.
I'm going to take my cunning action to take a stealth check to try and completely make sure I'm hidden again. Plus
okay.
15 to stealth.
Succeeds.
Alright, and then, since I'm within 10 feet of Holy Kaiser, I still have a bead on his location. And I am going to cast...
Well, you can see through the fog, can't you?
Blind sense relies on hearing, I think. Because it's blind sense, not blind sight.
It is blind okay. sight.
Mine is blind sense.
Well, because you wrote blind sense on the paper.
Yeah, if you are able to hear, you are aware of the location of any hidden or invisible creature within 10 feet of you. So, it relies on my hearing to do it, not my actual sight. If
sure.
I got deafened, then I wouldn't be able to do it. But, I am going to cast the level 1 spell, Grease. And I am going to, it causes a 10-foot square, so I'm going to do the center. I want it to be centered, like, right on this square, so that's these.
It is blind sense.
Yeah.
I just looked it up.
It's interesting.
So it's a 10-foot... It is a 10-foot square centered on a point in range. So we're going to do it up here. Or I want to do it like up here and just catch him with like a corner of it and kind of block off this area so he can't slip by super easy.
Because so, like, he'd slip.
Yeah. So, like, maybe right in here. It's gonna catch. It might catch Aller too if I do that, though. So,
I just okay, imagine like up. Holy Kaiser in his full glorious mithril plate, just kind of like just catching himself. He's doing that stifled walk where they're like constantly like, oh god, ah.
Okay. Oh god.
Oh my god, it's got the... Of course, it's not a PNG. Well, I can just make a circle.
All right.
Draw a circle. How big
Didn't
is the
Didn't you say it was
the
a square?
Grease pile?
It is a 10-foot square of grease.
It's a square?
10-foot square centered on a point in range.
Okay, what's the length? I'm sorry.
It's 10-foot square.
Foot square. Okay.
Small.
Where is this about where you wanted it?
Do it one.
Yeah.
One more over. To the right.
Yeah, one more over to get.
There you go.
Kaiser, just about.
Yeah, he definitely and, like his entire pack just got.
Yep, and so you need to make a dex check real quick.
If you make him fall on his ass.
I'll save 18 real quick, buddy.
18. He has a 7 to dex.
I'm just imagining all the videos I've seen of people slipping on ice and everything, and it's just the Kaiser.
23.
So he keeps his footing like a boss.
Does he have a disadvantage because it's smoke cloud, he didn't know any of this was coming, and then now he's just slipping?
God damn it. Okay, yeah.
Yes!
That's 12. Yes. Holy Kaiser just falls flat on his fucking back.
Holy Kaiser he slips and falls prone.
I love it.
Not that you needed another thing to have an advantage against him, but yes, he is now fallen in the grease.
Wait.
He's the grease machine now.
Too bad he's resistant to fire, or else this would be a perfect little trap.
Elfric will end his turn, and that'll trigger his regeneration, and he'll regenerate 20 points of health.
Yep.
And that'll be the end of Elfric's turn.
Real quick,
Elfric's had a pretty fulfilling night.
My last legendary action, I'm going to do that third tail attack.
Yeah, you have advantage. Yeah.
Quadruple.
Okay, succeeds.
Just gotta sneak it in before my turn. 23 damage.
Okay. It is now your turn.
Actually, Alaric will just, move over a little bit. So he's not just fighting right over Terry. Not like it matters, but... Okay, he's gonna start swinging with his claws. Advantage. Nat 20 on the first claw.
Yeah.
22 on the second claw.
Both hit.
And for the bite, 30.
But yep, all that hits.
All
give
right.
Me that damage.
Let's do the first bite with a crit. So that's 10 doubled, so 20 plus 8, so 28 damage for the claw. Second claw, which is normal, is 19 damage. So that's what, 30, 47 damage.
Okay.
And then for his big old bite, we got 18 on top of that.
Base is 65 divided by 2, 32.5, so 32 damage. Not a bad round for not having a radiant weapon.
Not bad. And that's, and I will let go of Alar, as he's exclaimed a few times that he's, like, now snapped out of it. So Alar is free.
Alar, is now your first unstopped, unabridged turn. against Holy Kaiser.
Aller's gonna just fly right over here immediately. And he's just gonna lay the hammer. Let me check what Mjolnir's. Where'd that sheet go? Is this the sheet? This is the sheet. Let's check Mjolnir's spells real quick. Okay, yeah, there's nothing too interesting there. Plus 11 to hit with Mjolnir.
Are you gonna do any smites?
Well, we get to see on the smites after I hit. We're gonna see if I can see if I can add that divine smite. So we're gonna do a d20 plus 11. See if I hit. That's a 30.
So Aller can't see in the fog either, right?
Oh yeah, Aller's at disadvantage.
Aller can't see, but he's prone, so it washes out to just the roll.
Which means it's a 30.
Which means it's a 30. Which means it hits.
Yeah, we'll try the second attack now to just see. And then second attack was a 1.
Okay.
So first attack, we're gonna let's look at Alish. So we're gonna add a what spell slots do I have available? Pretty much all of them. I think we're gonna burn one of my 2 level 5 spell slots on Divine Smite here. Which, okay, with improved smite, let me scroll down. Whatever you hit with a melee weapon attack, the target takes an extra D8 radiant damage.
Okay.
So I get, and then with the actual Divine Smite feature, it is, where's, I know Smite is on here somewhere. Would it be under spells?
Yeah.
No?
Wouldn't it?
Sorry.
Oh.
It don't look like it. Yeah. Actions.
Where is,
would it be a other improved Divine Smite does a D8. Divine Smite, when you make a melee weapon attack, you expend one spell slot to deal 2d8 extra radiant damage to the target. Plus 1d8 for each level higher. And I did 5th level, so that's 5d8. And then I have improved Divine Smite, which adds an extra D8 on top of that. So 6d8.
Okay.
6d8. For just the smiting damage. This is all radiant, so it'll be doubled. That's 24, so 48. That's not including the weapon damage from Mjolnir, which is a 3d10 bludgeoning and 1d10 lightning. So we'll roll d10 for the lightning. So 5 lightning. And then 3d10 of just pure, good old-fashioned blunt damage.
Just blunt force trauma coming in.
Plus the plus 5 modifier for my strength. So that's a 13.
And the radiant.
The radiant is the 24, which doubled, so 48.
Okay, hold on. Let me unpack all this damage here. Okay, so starting with okay. So the 24 is the first damage, right?
The 24 is the radiant, yeah.
So that is 48.
Yeah.
Okay. And then 5. What's the 5?
5 is electric. Lightning.
Thunder, yeah. Or lightning, yeah, lightning damage.
Okay, he takes the full 5. And the 13 is the bludgeoning.
13 is the bludgeoning from Mjolnir, yeah.
From, like, the magical weapon.
Yeah.
Okay. You come in, like, the full, like, when...
I also get the option for my Radiant Soul, which I activated last turn, to inflict an extra 20 of Radiant onto this, which I'll do.
Let's do that.
20, so another, so 40 another radiant.
40 I can only do it on one attack.
It's just a flat 20?
It's just a flat 20. At least according
Okay, so another 40. Okay. He has definitely taken radiant. Fill
that
box.
Got rocked with a hammer.
So, I mean, the scene where, like, Thor, like, is coming down on the Bifrost Bridge, you know, and just, but with Mjolnir, just pow! Right on Holy Kaiser's chest. Now, the mithril armor has withstood everything up until the stabbing with Elfric. Okay? It folds like paper beneath Mjolnir. Like it's made of just normal steel or iron. Like, his chest is obliterated from this. Like, at least, like, blood, guts. He's not doing hot from this. An explosion of radiant sears it. Like Mjolnir cuts through the mithril plate. And then immediately after that, Alar slips in the grease.
God damn it.
Alar slips and cracks the back of his head in the grease.
Ow!
His coolest and most embarrassing moment in one.
So you are now laying next to Holy Kaiser, and like, you can't see his face, but I guess Alaric and Elfric can. And like, he is just like, laying there, like pain, real pain on his face, like just shaking, like. It's past the point of just like constant disbelief that he's being hurt. This is just like, you're starting to see things like panic enter into his eyes.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yeah, he should be panicking.
Yep.
And that's probably a good time to.
Yeah. We're gonna end it at the top of the turn with Holy Kaiser. With him and Alar laying prone together in the grease.
Mud wrestle.
We're getting greasy tonight, boys.
We're getting greasy, fuck yeah.
Elfric accidentally lights it on fire. Oops. Sorry, Alar. I didn't need him for my plans.
God dang. How's he... So he's, you know, on a...
I think I pretty accurately just described his current state.
Nah. Elfric's big goal right now. First, we gotta take out Holy Kaiser, then we gotta take out Asmodeus.
That was a swift, like, because it didn't feel like your attacks were, like, really hurting him. It just felt like his skin was made of, like, just, it was tough. Like, you couldn't chomp through it. Like, your claw attacks, like, all, like, you just felt like you were being a nuisance, like, bruising him at the most. Like, and then he just hits you with this walloper, like, Alaric. Mm-hmm. But then Elfric appeared behind him and stabbed him, and that was real pain. And then this was something altogether different.
Got straight rocked.
Fuck yeah.
That being said, the weakening breath, though, was big play.
Oh yeah, it's been helping. God damn.
They're both down in the grease.
Hell yeah, guys. And I am gonna end that here.
Fuck yeah.